They think they can hear us now.
I'm going to see if they can. Let me know.
What was that?
All right. He's saying it looks like they're on.
Oh, no. They hear us.
They can hear us. And then check this shit out if I want to.
I love that fucking picture.
That's great. I actually recorded one of those today.
Bada bing. Look at that.
Oh,
I can do that from here.
What's up?
And I can even do, since we haven't done any sort of noise checking yet or anything like that, I can also add that from here.
Yeah.
You're here to adjust audio.
Yeah, you're here to make sure things run well, Stefan.
You're basically here to listen to the headphones and make sure we're not peaking or falling apart.
And make sure we don't get too drunk.
And occasionally chiming in if you have something of interest.
Although I will say, if after about 30 minutes,
it might be okay. Yeah, if it's feeling like your services are no longer required, you can also head out early if that's what it's looking like. But
Honey,
at this
Bazzer,
point, I'd probably...
Hope your run went well.
Mm-hmm. At this point, I'd probably get that update video done rather than leave.
Oh, well, that too. But either way, that's how it goes.
That is true. We do need everybody to know that we will be at Anime Expo 4th of July weekend.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
How will they know without an update video coming out tomorrow?
Coming out tomorrow, that update video that will let you know that we're going to be at Anime Expo.
Before we do too much, I'm just going to make sure people can see and hear everything right.
And that everything's sunk up.
Yo, was that clap? Did that look like it timed right? Is it coming before or after he claps?
People saying it's in sync.
It's in sync.
Well, Zarok
bye,
is.
Bye, bye.
Also, yeah, Tyler's not here.
People are saying perfect sync. Saw someone saying there was some stuttering in the video. Let me know if that keeps happening. I upped our bit rate a little bit because our last couple streams have looked ago, and I feel like we've got better internet than that.
So we definitely do. We're paying for it.
But I might have overestimated or something may be amiss.
All right. Let me pull up my list here to see who gave us this booze. This is Teenage Rampage Daddy.
Yo, thank you, Teenage Rampage Daddy.
Gifting us this Meadow Junmai Ginjo Sake from Mura Mura. I think we're out of pre-show now, huh?
Oh, yes. Sorry.
No worries.
Get it.
This is supposed to have hints of melon.
You did it.
It's great when the butt is in use. It takes away the text on it, and the text on it is pre-show. So I have to figure it out.
I'm just using this guy to get myself back in the groove.
Now don't use him to get our first drink.
Grant, would you like a,
I would. Nicely done.
Not all that nice.
I mean, not the greatest.
You still got a kill on me, which is just total garbage. I'm the worst.
You're going to get that as much in your way as possible.
No problem.
Going to ruin everyone's livers.
Mm-hmm. Muda Muda, thank you to Teenage Rampage Daddy. They requested that we call them Daddy.
TRD.
So it's in quotation marks next to Teenage
Daddy.
Rampage. There they are. Just call me Bottle Daddy. You got it, Bottle Daddy.
All right, Bottle Daddy.
Speaking of daddies, I'm going to go get ruined by my daddy right now.
But Scott, you've got a stream going
on. Yeah, we're going on. You got to like at least
you
cancel a little bit, postpone.
Oh, you mean this day.
Tōsan. Shine yo kudasai.
Papa-chan.
Oh, they wanted you to call
the bottle daddy. Okay, the bottle is
The bottle is the daddy.
Thank you, Teenage Rampage, for this daddy.
Thank you for gifting us daddy.
Who is baby?
Daddy, let me get some sip.
No, not yet. You have to die first.
First of all, I can drink whenever I want.
I mean, it's true.
You can. You're an adult, but you're not abiding by the rules of the game. See, I brought agua fresca to drink in the interim.
I'm actually going to grab myself a bottle of water. Do you want one, Scott?
Oh, please.
I'll take a bottle of water as well, actually. I'm running low on agua fresca.
I'm saying agua fresca.
Agua fresca. Welcome. Now, see, the other way is definitely, like, a whiter way to say it. Watermelonade. That's what I also call it.
Gotta hit square. Square is the way up.
It's hip to be square. Circle, actually. Circle is how you get up. Circle and a direction, left or right, typically.
Oh,
I'm definitely gonna lose, but that's okay.
Don't say that. You got this. There you go. He didn't see that coming.
Oh, nope, nope. Ah, damn it.
Hey, who needs to heal?
Not me.
This is the dude who trained you, taught you what it means to be a shinobi.
Now he's teaching you what it means to be a corpse.
Un papa.
Unfortunately, I'm a bad learner!
In both respects.
Oh god, no.
Nice.
I may definitely lose this, but I'm not gonna go down without a fight, you fuck.
You may definitely.
May definitely may possibly lose this, potentially.
Almost certainly maybe.
I hate how he jumps back after that. Let me hit you. Let me hit you!
I do think your instinct to run is turning against you.
I'm trying to fight it. I'm trying to fight it so much.
Check this out, Stefan. I can do it from here. Mm. Yeah.
Mm. That's pretty good. That's pretty. It's interesting.
I've seen some people say that they it's kind of a. Oh no! Oh, what's is something's happening with your face, Nick?
Daddy has a interesting funk to him.
Hmm. What were you saying?
I saw some people saying that they found it kind of annoying that Owl is so big, but from a character design perspective, I really like that.
You love his big hulking.
Yeah,
it's cool. I love it.
Yeah, it makes him imposing. It makes him makes him seem authoritative.
Just look at him.
He's larger than life. He's got some big boots to fill if he had boots.
You're going to have to stand up tall to suck my dick, Wolf.
It's not just in the story that he's daddy. He looks like a daddy.
Yeah, he's got a dad bod for sure.
He's definitely a G-Dilf.
And you look like baby.
Thanks, Frostbit Warlock, for the bits.
He's a super gilf. A great shinobi I'd like to fuck.
Nice.
So far. All right.
Avoiding lots of hits. I always like that.
Ah, damn. Oh,
wow.
Damn.
That was a hit.
Daddy's a murdering psychopath.
Got to back on.
Oh, man.
The first death is such a quick get up. It's easy to forget that everything gets unlocked and set back to default. I wish there was just a slight chance he could jump too far backward and just falls off the tower and dies.
I know, right? Damn it.
Whoops! Epic fail, Wolf! As he drops to his demise.
I think I abused Chasing Strike with him. He's really bad about blocking Chasing Strike.
Oof.
What's Chasing Strike?
Strike!
Which one's Chasing Strike?
Chasing Strike is the attack you do right after you throw a shuriken.
Yeah, if you just press R1 right after R2, basically.
There are a couple other things that do it, too. The firecrackers do it. This does Chasing Strike.
I wouldn't be surprised if the axe or the flame vent do it, but I haven't tried.
The axe is something different. The axe is like you hit it down and then you do this weird flip attack thing.
Oh, right. Fucking.
I'm so mad at you.
You're bad.
I am so mad at my son.
You're a bad boy and I'm going to punish you over and over.
Right.
Don't make daddy get his belt, Wolf.
See, that's his Chasing Strike. It's kind of cool that he does just do bigger versions of your moves.
He's your teacher. Except for you don't really have that kick.
Yeah, you do. That's the Goomba Stomp.
He doesn't have to jump on you to do it, I guess, is what I'm saying.
That's fair. I mean, he's taller than you, so.
Yeah.
But he does the Nightjar approach.
He's got that flip. Woo! Nice.
Oh, damn it. No, no, god damn it.
Another good thing against him is, in fact, the flame vent because he wears all those rags.
Does like to catch on fire.
It's even better if you know how to use the oil on him, too. Oil up, daddy, and then light him ablaze.
Jesus Christ.
Sorry, I didn't mean to excite you.
Soak your daddy in oil while you suck on some candy and let his flame burn.
Nope, no.
I wish you could smack it out of the air. Or knock it back to him.
Yeah, if you could, like, parry shit like that, that'd be kind of neat.
Woo!
Can Kaiser use any items to make this easier, Lanny? Yes.
Yeah, I can. I'm trying a couple without it just to get a hang of him. If I use them right now and then I fail, it's going to be bad.
Yeah, he also hasn't played for, like, a week, so.
Yeah.
Getting his sea legs back. Didn't have a half hour of warming up like we did last week either.
Yeah, so it is really better that I do this now. Come on, you fuck. Oh, okay. Or that.
Ooh.
That was interesting.
Getting a little brave there, but it worked. Oh, God! Okay.
No.
Dog.
Oh, that was stupid.
Daddy wasn't having none of that.
A little bit of sip, and here we go. Back at it again.
I just want to say the chat's being very nice to each other right now, and I really like that.
Yeah, oh, yeah. It's a wholesome chat. Wait till they get a few drinks in them.
Woo!
Then it's a party. That was an interesting audio glitch.
Oh, man.
Oh, no.
Wouldn't be a FromSoft game if Trevor didn't fight you some.
The unseen enemy, the camera.
More like the unseeing enemy. Ha!
Oh! Got him.
Because I can't see him.
Because of the camera.
Because of the camera.
Yeah.
Speaking of camera, I think Tyler also has it set it up for me to do stuff like this.
Uh-oh.
Oh!
Look, there's Scott.
Oh, hey.
Behind the three.
Behind the three. It's... Oh, fuck. I wasn't paying attention. Fuck.
Just as planned. No one's in that seat. There's a little bit of Nick. Isn't that cool?
I can move over this way.
I can also adjust it, but I won't.
And hey, there's me. But I know these things need to be up in a specific order because they're all on top of each other, and I don't know it, so I'll probably only use those occasionally. That is easier to do from the computer.
Because you can see what they are.
Eventually we'll have them set up on here to be in their stack.
DJ Nerd Rage, thank you for the 300 bits.
Yo!
He died.
Got him.
He died.
He died a fool's death.
Wait, did I actually rust?
Yes. Yeah, okay. You can tell because your health is full.
Okay, this time I sneak. Stop. Yoink, yoink. And up we go.
Yo, Papa-san. Nani the fuck up with you.
Daddy-chan.
All right. I think this is going to be my last warm-up round, and then I'm going to start using
items. Okay, this is the last fake one.
Okay. After this, he picks his real color. Nice.
Ooh, my food will be here in 9 minutes.
Oh boy. Yeah, no, yeah. Ooh,
nope.
little too greedy, but I like the stay on him.
This game does promote aggression.
It gets me pretty fucking aggressive.
You gotta be aggressive, but measured aggression. You gotta know when you're coming in that you're Swing at the owl, best not miss, such and such. Get away!
I won't lie, all that for a drop of blood is a pretty good fucking quotable line that people have been using lately.
Yeah. Wow, out of range. That interesting. I guess that thing has a smaller range than I thought.
Yeah, I think if you are not in like the green part of it, you are fine.
Huh.
Like, I think that smoke that
But that time, though.
No, yeah. Never mind. Maybe I'm wrong.
Weird.
Maybe it doesn't go in a real circle. And
maybe that's like one of those like weird cardioid shapes.
Yeah, the hitbox for that seems a little ambiguous.
So jump in. Now you punish.
Oh, damn it.
Ah, too much running.
Can't heal yet.
You need to hold guard at some point to regenerate your...
Oh!
Oh, what? I thought I... Okay. All right, I'm mad about that one, actually. I'm not happy.
It's only half the fight. You've only died once.
For shadows, they died
what?
Twice.
What? God damn it.
Stop running.
I'm trying to get out of the way.
Just straight tapping dash is usually better for that.
All right, see, so that's why I ran.
Fair enough.
It is a more generous timing if you just book it. You do have to kind of time a step, sidestep.
Yeah. Sometimes you have that timing, sometimes you don't.
But you got him deep in his posture line, and his health is pretty low.
Come on, do a thing. That's fine.
Here comes the jump.
What? Woo. Oh, goddamn. Oh,
yeah, keep clicking the left stick while you're running. You're just going to duck to the ground. And that slide animation takes a while.
Double shuriken. No. I know there's a way you can cheese this AI to make it do exactly what you want with positioning.
I've been actually trying to learn that myself, but I'm doing poorly.
You're not that bad. I mean,
you got three drinks still, and you've almost got this first health bar down. That's not a terrible run.
And you still have pellets too.
Really, not a bad run at all.
Woo.
Nope.
Ah.
That greedy.
Ah. No. Damn it. That wasn't greedy. That was just mistimed.
Don't worry, dude. It was a warm-up. As you said, this is the real one.
We all heard it. Now you mean it.
Now you can be embarrassed.
Which means you've just set the bar, Scott. If you do any less than that, obviously you lied.
I'm about to get totally hunky up in here.
Because now if it counts any lower than that, I'll be disappointed.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's see here.
You can add more things to your
quick bar
if you want. That said, if you use it only once in a fight, it might just be better to not have it in the way when you're trying to swap.
Like not putting sugars on that bar, I wouldn't do that.
Yeah,
like
sure
at the end of the at the end of the game, I think my bar consisted of divine confetti, pellets, my gourd, and I think that's about it.
I had gourd, pellets, confetti, and oil. I used fire enough on... Whenever I came up on an enemy that I was like, I'm not sure how to do this, I just oiled him and set him on fire, and it worked like every time.
It apparently works very well on Father. Dad on fire is...
I might do this one.
La Volpa, thank you for the bit, saying, you got this, Scott, kick his butt! There you go. La Volpa believes in you.
Grazie.
Are you going to let down La Volpa?
I would.
I'm definitely gonna. At least immediately.
La Volpa, does that mean the bunny?
That sounds right.
I'm surprised you know that bunny is Vulp.
Thank you, Tagus.
It's more just knowledge of language than anything else.
You too. Isn't Lupus also rabbit?
Fox. No, Lupus. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah,
Lupus.
Yeah.
Vulpe is fox.
Oh, Vulpine, yeah. Oh, wait. Oh, yeah, you're right.
Lupine.
Fuck.
Lupine the third.
Lupin. Well, Lup is wolf.
Yeah. Lupin is Wolf Lepus. Yeah.
Lepus. That's right.
I only know that because of the horror movie, Night of Lepus.
Yes.
All right.
Like Vulpix. There you go. There's your.
There you go. There's how I learned that.
Autonomic learning thing.
Lapine. That's
like Lapras.
Yeah, like the bunny, Lapras.
Lapany.
Actually, yeah.
That's low funny, so it's not quite.
Doesn't matter. Again, it's that. It's
not quite.
Weird shape. Nice.
I can't wait for him to not get hit the whole time the sugar's in play and then start taking damage.
Right?
I've definitely done that multiple times.
Just wasting it, like,
I'm going to use the defensive one. Yep.
I only ever use the blue one for, like, learning runs, basically. Because, like, I just want to live as long as I can. And if I win, bonus, but...
pick up as much of this as I can.
Yeah, the red sugar is your serious sugar. Wow. Huh. That was a delayed ball.
It wasn't that delayed. Oh, God. Oh, no.
Felt pretty delayed.
You feel pretty delayed.
I don't know. I mean, I'm usually pretty timely.
So, question from the comments. Did Lanny and Grant ring the bell in their playthroughs?
Yes. Oh, for this? I did not.
Okay, so
I didn't do it for the whole playthrough. I did it for, like, the last part of it.
Hmm.
Because it's, like, I don't even think we've shown Kaiser the bell.
Nah. I don't think he's been there. But when I heard what it did, I was like, eh, that sounds like a New Game Plus thing that I might check out, but for now, no.
It's great for grinding because it
I can see that.
Gets better items. Like, you get a higher chance of drop rates and shit.
Okay. Really thought there was going to be a second slash there that would get you.
My food is arriving soon.
Do you want me to go intercept it, Nick?
That would be great, actually. Should be right out front pretty shortly. Tahuana is delivering my burrito.
Ooh.
That chasing slice!
Knew he was coming. Where was it,
nope!
Daddy says no!
Son, I am disappointed that you would heal so quickly.
Rang it on accident, just wanted to see what it did. Luckily, you can ring it a second time and it, like, you just turn it off. Yeah.
Ooh!
Drake! So was that better than before? I don't...
No, that was worse.
Oh, okay.
That was definitely worse.
I believed in him more.
Oh, okay.
Fair
enough.
Oh, my God.
I'd get that at a point score higher, I think, because he tried some stuff there that I liked.
Yeah.
Wore out a whole sugar before he took damage.
Yeah, even got hit.
And then I got hit a bunch.
Yes. Therein lied the problem.
Makes me wonder if I should even bother with the sugars.
Well, the red sugar is actually very good because it hurts him more.
Yeah, but it also has
Thank you, Stefan.
Scott, while Daddy makes
you mad...
And thank
you, Freebird Burrito.
While Daddy makes you mad, do you want me to tell you about how Mortal Kombat made me mad earlier today?
Oh, no.
So I was playing some ranked games, and that means I was fighting Scorpion because he's the only person anyone online plays. And I crush him round one, just destroy him. But then he comes back round two, and he fucking teabagged me during the finish.
Oh, fucker.
Gave you the mercy?
He didn't do the mercy, but he teabagged me, and it made me really mad. So then I beat him, and then mercy him, and then teabag while he is able to attack. Avoid his scorpion spear while I'm teabagging and uppercut him and kill him. And
that's great.
It was great.
Yes! Yes!
Felt very, very good. But then right after that, found another scorpion, destroyed me, teabagged me the whole time, and I couldn't touch him, and I was really mad.
It sucks that there's only one meta character.
It's, well, here's the thing. Scorpion has the great mix of being the most annoying character to fight and the easiest character to use.
Yep.
It's just a real bad combo online.
I took a swing at a different game that recently came out called Teamfight Tactics.
No, no.
Ooh.
Not yet.
Oh,
not yet.
Oh, I almost hit it.
It's from the guys that made League of Legends.
Okay.
And it's essentially what's known as an auto chess game, where you collect your heroes and you place them on the board. There you go. Drake!
Hit me.
Okay. Okay.
I didn't say daddy.
Pass that bottle over when you fill yours also.
No problem. I got to fill mine too. Get rid of some of daddy's funk here. I guess it's like it's
funky
grown
daddy.
On it's grown on me a little bit here, but it's
I think that's just the alcohol, Nick. I feel like every sake I will initially go, I don't know if I like this, but by the time the bottle's dead, I'm like, you know, that wasn't too bad.
I, honestly, this one, like the melon flavor was way too obnoxious, like the back end melon flavor.
Yeah.
Like it's still like not my favorite, but I decided to get us a sampler platter.
I'm going to say this. Melon is never a good flavor for almost anything ever.
I don't necessarily agree.
It is
not an artificial flavor, maybe.
Yeah.
I don't know. We had those J-List melon milk candies.
Yeah, the candies.
Those were really good, actually.
I really loved those.
So okay, awesome. Actually, for liquor, melon and liquor, never, ever,
liquor
ever.
Melon.
The company Midori would strongly disagree with you.
I'd lick her melons, if you know what I mean. We're already
Dude's
there.
Corner.
Wait, is Midori melon?
Yeah.
Huh.
Also, for people asking, I'm currently maining Shang Tsung, so I really, really like him.
That way you can become Scorpion.
Yes, actually, I've done that too. I'm playing Shang Tsung as an excuse to somewhat learn every character while maining my own. Which really works out when my previous main, Noob Saibot, another popular online character, shows up and I can turn into him and be like, I know how this works.
Talon of the Dragon asks, who are we drinking anyways?
Right now we're drinking Daddy from Teenage Rampage.
Thanks, Teenage Rampage! Who named his bottle.
Mm-hmm.
Is that Freebirds?
Mm-hmm.
Oh my god, it smells really fucking good.
You can tell
it
Scott's been very focused. He didn't pay attention when that was said multiple times.
God damn it, I ran into the fucking door.
That's right, and that's what you tell the cops.
I was hoofing at your comment, not at the danger on screen. Oh, yeah, just keep him here. He can't go anywhere. He's got nowhere to back up.
Yeah, where are you going now, Dad? I know that's actually a tactic against Genichiro, getting him pinned against that statue and just fucking him up.
That doesn't surprise me. Dude's a pushover. Remember how much trouble you had with him?
Oh, my God. Beating him was one of the great fucking monuments I've had in this game. I loved defeating that fucker. That was amazing.
Hey!
You mind backing up, Dad? Dad, would you stop? Please stop.
There aren't very many enemies in this game who can heal themselves, are there?
Most of them are just posture healing.
People keep in the chat keep referring to me as Tyler, and I feel like my voice sounds very different.
It does. You're off screen.
We're all Tyler when we're over here.
Yeah. Tyler's just the nickname for anyone who's working.
Yeah, Tyler isn't a person.
It's a place. And that place is tech. Good.
His posture hasn't gone back up any, so you're in a good place. He is pushing this offensive. Oh no!
You turned your back on Daddy. Drink!
I can't remember. Is there like a flanking damage bonus in this? Like, do things hit harder if they hit you from behind?
I don't know.
Because I think
I never turned my back on an opponent.
I think that's a thing in Dark Souls. I know counter hitting is definitely a thing in Dark Souls and this. I might be thinking Mordhau with the flanking stuff.
Maybe. Yeah, anyway, I tried out a game of that team fight tactics thing.
Yeah.
Won my first game. Just nice. Because it pairs you against like 9 other people, and it kind of goes in a round. And after you, like, if you lose a battle, you lose a chunk of your health, and it's kind of an elimination system.
Okay.
I won, hands down. Had 93 health at the end. You start with 100. Easy. Easy first game.
Does sound all right.
People in the chat are just going off about this Tyler thing, but I have a thing that's going to blow their minds. My middle name is actually Tyler.
Fuck! He was Tyler all along!
So he lied to you, chat.
Stefan Tyler Prosex?
That is my name.
And what's your social security number,
Stefan
Tyler Prosex?
With this much
Prosex?
Information, I can almost figure out your credit card information.
You know what's fascinating, guys? Mother's maiden names. Shall we go around?
Yeah, what's all of yours?
I mean, I feel like this is very easy to find information.
Yeah, with even like a cursory Google search.
I'm kind of mad my mom, like, I couldn't take my mom's maiden name.
That was a cool maiden name?
Yeah.
And what would that
throat
be?
Throat puncher.
I could have been Scott Black. Then again,
you would have had to have been a musician.
It is a catchier name than Frerichs.
Yes.
Well,
it rolls off the tongue better, certainly.
If I ever wanted to break into acting, I'd have to change my last name, because right now it's not a great time to be a Landis in Hollywood.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck.
I feel like it won't be for a while now.
Yeah, I'm thinking Landon.
Yeah, maybe.
Nick Landon, I can see that.
Oh, man, then just anytime you go to a city, just Landon in Pennsylvania,
yeah,
check
it
out.
There you go, there you go.
Landon in L.A.
Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo!
The sliver of health! Heal it before he takes away your power. Yo, thanks, Everett. Everett the Rop. Thank you for the 10 months.
There you go. If you throw some oil at him before that, it really fucks him up.
No.
Ooh, Landers with a Z.
Mm. Lander's a good one. Chris Gregg says Lander.
Lander's not a bad.
Yeah.
Nick Lander.
All right. So
I think it sounds too goofy, though. Nick Lander.
Lander, yeah.
Like Landon. It sounds like, you know, you could put that in a lot of things.
Yeah, that's got some power behind it. So I'm William Grant Smith, and I never really know how I should be credited. I go by Grant Smith typically, just in like conversation when I introduce myself to people.
And I even mark you down as Grant Smith in a lot of things.
And I think that's fine, but like I don't know if W. Grant Smith would look more like sophisticated.
That's if you're an author.
He's got a Mercury counter.
Yes, he does.
No.
He has almost all of your tricks except for your prosthesis.
If I was a jazz musician, I'd be Willie G. Smith.
If you want to be the most boring person alive, you can name yourself Bill Smith.
Bill Smith. I could just be the most combination.
That would be if you wanted to be a senator.
Senator Bill Smith. Yeah, no, that works. Anyways,
no.
Sound off in the chat if you have a fun way to refer to William Grant Smith and you think that would look good in a byline.
Yo, Slush Pup with the 25 hundo.
Yo!
Putting that name on a bottle. Hey guys, here's for a bottle. Kaiser, you got this. I beat this game and you improve much faster than I did.
Hey, there you go.
There you go. There's your motivation, Kaiser.
Especially somebody who only plays once a week.
Bam!
Boom!
There's
first
the first
bar down.
And only 7 drinks in.
No.
Right, where'd he go?
Snarlfox is right. That W.G. Smith sounds pretty great.
I do like that.
That sounds like a turn of the century author.
Yeah, I was gonna say that was kind of what I was thinking maybe for an author.
Yeah.
W.G. Smith is great. I'd go with it.
All right, maybe that's what I'll just ask to be on.
W. Grant Smith is what you are when you're an explorer.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go around the world.
All right. If I'm in anime or anything from now on, W.G. Smith might be what you see.
No.
That's what I was thinking, and if chat's already agreeing.
I just understood why your old username is what it is.
Yep. Yep.
It wasn't until I learned that Grant wasn't his actual name that I figured that out.
Right. Yeah. The WGS has always been a mystery.
I only just now made
a lot of
connection.
People started using it on a Smash Brothers forum. A lot of people thought it was World Game Series whenever they saw it.
Huh. You want to tap over on the D-pad in a sec too, to get to your pellets.
Now you're just healing over time and it's a lot faster to trigger it.
Woo!
Also, I like busting out the whatchamacallit, the sparks here. I think this is a good idea.
Firecrackers are very good on pretty much any human opponent. You just gotta capitalize as soon as you do it.
Yeah.
But
yeah, they'll punish you if you don't catch them, but you can't heal yet.
Oh no, I thought it.
You still got another life. Still got another life. That said, if you use it now, you won't have it for the next fight.
For part 3.
No.
Something to keep in mind.
Just saying, the last time you fought up here, there were 3 parts.
Woo!
Here comes the smoke.
Every time I see that, I think it looks like a grab.
Yeah, grabs
coming
from
in from
him
overhead
are real
to just get
bad.
Your head.
Ah, you turned your back. Jump.
I know you take extra damage if you're in the air. I wonder if you take extra damage while you're running.
You probably do. I can't imagine that have some sort of backstab something.
I was going to say, I feel like running is something they kind of actively discourage, so if it doesn't punish you for getting hit during it, I'd be surprised.
It doesn't matter if he hits you with that now. You can't heal.
Yeah, you're out of healing stuff, so you might as well,
Punish him when he does it.
He's
point,
taking
actually.
Nothing from you. Also, you are out of sparks, too, just so you know.
Yeah, he has no nothing. Get him! Here comes the flippy.
Oh, you got it,
man.
You're right, this is toxic.
Right?
Yeah, you can hit him during that, too.
Ooh, whoa! Damn!
That was so fucking cool! If you don't kill him now, it's gonna be real disappointing after
that. Yeah, that'd be straight sacrilege if you don't after that.
Now all the pressure's on. Get away!
Oh, shit!
Did he just buff himself?
Yeah. Get him!
Aw, damn it! I'm so used to that.
No, yeah.
It's muscle memory.
Yeah,
I feel ya.
Yeah, I'm not going to criticize you for not being able to punish that.
Oh, shit.
That's a tough one. You've got a lot of unlearning to do. Yeah!
To the fallen foe!
Oh, my fucking God.
Drink!
You taught me well.
That's my boy.
Bravo, Scott.
Next!
I gotta do this first before I can feel okay.
No, yeah.
Oh my fucking God. That was 3 weeks of this cocksucker!
Way to do!
Three weeks!
And you can eat his memory.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh my God.
Eat your memory of killing your father.
Enhance attack power.
Oh wait.
Did you make it through all three of those weeks without a Tootsie Roll Pop joke?
We didn't make one.
Actually,
no, we never made one.
There we go. That's the real victory here.
It's true. Glad you got that on your first try, Scott.
Oh, man.
First real try.
8 drinks in. Actually,
not
8,
bad at all.
You know what?
Considering we did 40 the last, 2 weeks.
Yeah. Pale Blood, Inc., thank you for the 5 hundo. Bitch, for a successful patricide.
Ugh.
Oh, remember how to play the rest of this game? Like when you explore and shit?
And you have to talk to people?
Hey,
weird.
I haven't talked to you in weeks. How are you doing, kiddo?
I miss you.
My son. Did you finally kill your dad? Jeez, what took so long?
Aww, he feels really bad that he made me kill his dad. My dad.
Slushpup, also 2,400 bits, and congrats, Kaiser.
Thanks, Slushpup. Arigato gozaimashita. Kimi no sake ga hontou ni oishii.
Gotta drink some water to counterbalance this liquor. So da na, Okami yo.
All right, should I talk to him more?
Almost everybody you should just talk to until you see them repeat stuff.
Yeah. And I think we're getting to the point where we can actually get to that second hidden boss. Which actually has 2 hidden bosses. Hmm. One's just a mini boss.
Yo, cheese
soda.
Cheese soda, 82. Thank you.
Oh, damn.
500.
Cheese soda sounds... Okay.
That's a...
Jones soda.
Yeah,
that's
a Jones soda flavor right there.
What kind of cheese, though?
If you want to make sure I don't want it, blue cheese.
They make that.
I'm sure they do.
I'd go for something interesting like Swiss or something.
Okay.
All right.
Honestly, one of the easiest things you could do is just mozzarella, because all you do is just use the mozzarella water.
Yeah, yeah. I personally
tastes like a string cheese.
be most willing to try Ashina an extra sake. Sharp cheddar.
A bottle of Ashina sake given by Emma. Sake is a drink meant for sharing. While it does not contain water from the fountainhead, it is made from the purest of waters, and it is a drink beloved by the people of Ashina.
Stop slouching.
If it's not from the fountainhead, it's not pure!
Doesn't count!
You don't have any seed to give Emma.
Deva, mata.
I don't know where all the gourd seeds are.
Gonna burn this incense.
I'm going to hit you with the blade that kills everything.
We don't have animation for him running his hand along the blade, so. It's fine, I'm only a little dead.
Extraordinarily nostalgic.
The sword that kills, like, that's the problem with giving you something that's called the sword that kills anything. When you use it, you should kill what you hit.
I mean, yeah.
Yep.
Like, they could have given it to you as sort of like an unusable tool, like it kills you when you use it or something, maybe? And give it that kind of power? But I don't know. And make it, like, just hard to hit with.
So there's a bunch of stupid stuff you have to do to get to the extra boss. Do you want me to just do it?
I mean, I don't know.
You can just point them and see it.
It's really, like, it's way more complicated than that, if I'm going to be honest.
Really?
Is it the snake stuff? Or is it, okay.
Well,
because that's the only thing
yes,
I know.
Yes, but no.
Okay.
That's really interesting.
I want you to try and talk him through it, at least. And if we can't...
You know what? Yeah, give me...
If it's falling apart, then sure. Because he did say he wanted to fight every boss.
Well, it's not that... this isn't about me not fighting the boss. I will fight the boss. He wants to get me to said boss.
I don't want to get you to said boss. I just want to unlock it.
Also, you do have, I believe, 5 skill points now, so you could get better...
Yeah, you can get that...
Better drink.
Better drink.
Acquire skills.
Which I think is the most expensive thing that's not an ultimate move.
Might be in this second.
Other
thing.
Tab.
Yeah.
There you go, back.
Oh, prosthetic cards.
Down there at the bottom. Boom.
There it is.
Now your gourd heals more every time you drink it.
Hooray. That's good. I'm glad.
What we were saving all those points for. All
right. Where am I? So where to next, fellows?
So let's see. You burned the incense. Go check the incense again. Talk to Emma again one more time also.
Emma.
The little talk option down there.
Oh, wait. Oh.
There's a third option. You have to talk to her a few times to get some shit out of the way.
Yeah, I think she's still talking about old stuff. Our young lord has some crazy cool blood. Hey, you don't seem as mean as when I first met you. It's as if you've grown on this journey, Wolf.
Talk to him again.
Yo. Ooh, what?
Yeah, he'll start giving you some stuff, too.
Okay, cool.
Oh, yeah, we also have to talk to that little girl again and give her shit. And
you're starting to talk about stuff that I don't really remember
it's really,
doing or
it
kept
is
a lot of track
really
of. So,
convoluted.
So I'm going to give you the... I will totally defer to your guidance.
Open that window right there.
This one?
Yeah.
Only thing I remember doing is going out of my way to make sure I got both them big snakes.
Well, then you had all the physical things you need to get the best ending, but you didn't get the best ending.
Okay.
Well, also, I don't think... Have you beaten it yet?
I have not beaten. After that Ashin fight, I just haven't gone back. Like,
Doko ikuno?
I have not been consistently trying or anything.
Where am I going?
Did you check the incense again?
Yes. Oh, wait, after I talked to him?
Yes.
Stupid. Welcome to FromSoft Games. If it does something.
I'm here. All
right, cool. You already have it. Never mind. You already smell like the stuff.
Oh.
So now go to the... Nope. That thing.
Warp. Yo, travel. Thank you, Everett, for the bits. Saying I love your faces.
To Inner Sanctum, I believe.
Inner Sanctum?
Yep, important places.
Okay.
We have to talk to this girl a few times before we can do the next thing.
People are saying you need to eavesdrop on the young lord?
Not yet.
Okay. Just wanted to make sure their concerns were heard.
Their concerns are heard and immediately discarded.
Hey, man. It happens sometimes.
But yeah, you will have to at some point.
You're welcome here.
The biggest pain in the ass is you have to request rice from her, but that means you have to use the rice you've already had. You still have rice.
Then what do I do?
You eat it.
Oh, okay.
Consume your rice.
It's a really good healing item, actually. So,
oh.
We'll probably find reason to eat it on our journey, but put it on your fast bar.
Okay, how do I do that?
If you go back to equipment, then down there. Look at that.
All right.
So, never mind. We'll have to come back here later. Go back to the thing. Teleporty doodle.
Did you never actually technically find that idol?
I guess not.
I guess not.
Oh, you know, you had to re-find it.
Oh.
Oh, right. All right.
Do we want to get that other thing?
Other thing.
Sunken Valley and... Which one? That one, Riven Cave.
I'm so glad they give you visual aids.
Yes, go inside said cave.
You know, now that I'm not going up against a boss, we're gonna drink a lot less.
Hey, that's fine.
We'll see.
Oh my god, last week was a nightmare. Oh my god.
Oh wait, is this not even it? God damn it! I fucking hate this. I don't even remember if there's a good way to get to that from a thing. I think go up.
It's a true sunken valley.
And we want to find a place with a shit ton of poison. Look down from here, actually. Into that valley.
Looking for the poison lake or whatever?
Yeah, jump down from here.
You'll be fine.
You'll be able to hook onto something.
All right.
Most likely. Probably. Maybe. Just make sure to keep mashing the button to hook onto shit.
Hey!
There you go. Yes, this way.
That was some Spider-Man shit.
That way. I don't think this is a place we've been.
Really?
Oh, there's always gotta be a fucking bunch poison of shit. Bog in a goddamn front stop.
Look to your left.
Yes.
To your left. The other left.
They know
that way. Into that cave.
They know everybody hates it and they do it anyway.
Yeah, you haven't been here because there's a shit ton of items.
I think he killed the people around here and then immediately fought the gorillas.
I think he's never been here.
Yeah, I know. He's
there's
right.
There's a guy in the tent to your left too. Your left.
Am I going this way?
Your left.
Oh, you want me to? Oh.
See, this is why I don't want to give directions.
Nah, see, this is why I want you to give directions.
All right.
Here's the thing. I have fun when things go wrong.
Hold on. Go back to purchase because he actually has some interesting shit, I thought. Nah, never mind. Just
nothing we can afford.
Purses and stuff. Oh, well. Never mind. Yeah, in the cave.
Chad, I haven't played Spider-Man since I beat it when it came out. Should I go back for the DLC?
DLC's pretty good.
Then again, Spider-Man was probably my favorite game of the year.
I would say Spider-Man might have been... It was definitely in my top three last year.
God of War was my game of the year last year. Far and away.
I also need to get back to God of War. I got like a little bit into it and never beat it.
I'm in the same position. I got a decent amount into the beginning, but nowhere near.
I feel like I got to the part where it opens up and went, okay, I'm going to take a break, and then just never came back.
For what?
That's the problem with games these days.
God of War.
Oh man, you know, if I weren't doing God of War, for it, like if I hadn't been doing it as a stream on this channel, I don't know if I would have been as into it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Poisoned.
Like to be completely honest, I didn't dislike it, but
didn't love it.
I didn't love it.
Grant, as somebody who likes Dark Souls, I think you'd like God of War.
I liked what I played. I can't remember what it was. I think. So I'm weird in that I feel like I have a very thin line for, I want you to have a lot of menus for me to work with, but if you go even slightly over my limit, I'm like, man, fuck this, too many menus. And I think God of War might have had too many things I had to deal with, but I can't remember.
Yeah, despite all its RPG elements, Dark Souls is usually pretty straightforward.
It is usually very, like, you set something kind of once or twice, maybe improve it a few times, and then you don't kind of go back to those menus all that much.
Yeah, it doesn't really encourage min-maxing or anything.
Yeah.
It's only like an RPG in name.
Yeah, but I've really noticed in myself that if I have to keep going into menus to do stuff throughout the course of a game, I tend to not like it.
Switch to Shuriken.
Poison
dude,
places are always the
hit.
Worst. In a fucking FromSoft game. That's actually when I quit in Bloodborne. When I got to that forest with all the fucking snakes.
Oh, that place.
I gave up.
That place does suck.
I was playing the game. I played for like 20
hours. Then
you
didn't even make it to the poison place.
Once you figure that place out, it's really not that bad. It's just purposefully designed to be hard to navigate.
Yeah, and it's one of those things where I just got bored.
And the whole place is built to look exactly the same.
Why are you not hitting them with the shuriken? It kills them in one hit.
I forget. God damn it.
Yeah,
There you go.
I'm one of those people, I never finish a FromSoft game. I play until I get
bored. They do nothing.
I never finished Demon Souls. I didn't finish Dark Souls for a long ass time. Dark Souls 2 was actually the first one I finished, and then I finished Dark Souls 3 and Bloodborne.
Yeah, I got about 40 hours into Dark Souls 3, and I was happy with that experience. I got bored, and I was like, okay, I'm done. I don't necessarily need to finish games, because I'm a filthy casual.
Everett with another 100 bits saying Red Dead Redemption 2 was my game of the year last year. Lanny was the only reason I bought the game.
It's a very good game.
It's a real good one. I also never finished that.
Story mode's very worth it. The online has gotten better. Apparently you can play poker now.
Yeah, I definitely want to mess up the online some more. Up.
There's two ridges above you.
Oh, shit.
I think a lot of people's issues with Red Dead Redemption 2 are very valid, but I actually was also enjoying it quite a bit.
Again, I suggest ignoring them.
For a second, I pulled you into a new room.
You're like Wall Masters in Zelda, except they don't take you places.
You're going, that's back the way you came, the way you're facing.
The fucking Geico dude just showing up all
He's
over the place.
He's gotta save you some insurance.
That's also the way you just came from.
So, this is where I'm going?
No, behind you. That way. Man, your sense of direction is appalling.
It's a dark cave, Nick. They go in
I just mean like in terms of north, south, east, west, recognizing which way you're facing.
I can't see which way is what in here.
Everything is snake.
It is one.
Everything
snake.
Is snake
know, maybe,
and cave.
Maybe I'm weird.
Yeah, I have no idea where you are, period, looking at it.
This.
God damn it.
It is like a narrow cave, but there's just a lot of similar geometry.
Yeah, it's all rocks and snake.
I guess it's just like it's a one-way cave to me.
Yeah.
Like there's further in and back out. Like those are the two directions.
Which I will say the big snake is kind of reminding me of God of War.
That old world snake.
Yeah. What is it? Yggdrasil? Is that his name?
No,
Jormungandr.
Oh, yeah.
The world serpent.
Yggdrasil's the tree.
So
yes.
I got to go face him, don't I?
That's not what I said, but you can do what you want.
God damn it.
Hmm.
I don't think he sees you.
Yeah, he doesn't give a shit.
He hasn't noticed you yet because we haven't gotten a little spike over you.
Wouldn't he smell you if he were a real snake?
He's not flicking his tongue out enough. Just throw a shuriken at him. Yeah.
Yeah, that'll learn it.
Bro moves. He's scared now.
Oh, fuck.
All right, we've learned something.
Okay. Head-on challenge. Maybe not the best. You keep tiptoeing in and out.
Going for it again? All right.
What the hell?
Yeah, that hitbox is weird.
Okay.
He definitely didn't touch you.
No, I like this. I like seeing you see what you
flail.
Can do here. All right.
I did this in a very non-conventional way, like the way you weren't supposed to.
Really? I'm
yes.
curious to hear about that after this.
I will
regale us.
Yes. Once you have solved this. Oh, got a monkey.
Look at that, a monkey.
Okay, now it's dead. Didn't kill you, though.
That's good.
That's cool. I'm glad it didn't do that.
Because then you have to do this again.
Okay.
That was me breathing in, not the snake.
They are inviting you over there, and then they push you for doing it.
Drink!
Damn it.
I do like that.
I
like,
muted mic, sorry.
I do like that in case you don't die, they do make sure you land on that platform again.
In my experience, the time I did die falling off there, you don't always.
Oh, really?
So it's just his angle that's been very good.
Okay, it's been, yeah, great
angle,
Scott.
So you have to find your way back there real quick.
Shouldn't be that tough. You got up there once.
Yeah, easy.
Wee-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo. His toe felt the ground on that one.
So has anybody been seeing the word of mouth about the new Spooderman movie?
I hear, nope. Like, I've been hearing it's pretty good. I've been hearing that most people have been enjoying it that have seen it.
Yeah.
But that's, you know, it's a Marvel movie. You kind of come to expect that, where it's just like, at worst, it's enjoyable.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I still need to see Toy Story 3. I've been hearing very good talk
four?
About it.
Four.
Or yeah. Four, yeah.
Yeah, I enjoyed it.
I know some people who haven't seen 3.
Yeah?
Did Are you they forget sad? Where you were again? There's another ledge right behind you.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, shit. You're right.
Oh.
I saw Toy Story 4. It made me cry twice.
Nice.
Really?
That yes.
Sounds like a thing I'll enjoy then.
I don't think Toy Story... wait, no. There was one part near the end that did it for me.
Quinn, it's you that never saw it? Oh, you are perpetually sad.
Quinn, I got chocolates here for you, by the way, for looking after my animals.
Ooh.
Also money for you for looking after my animals.
Don't give the chocolates to his animals. Thanks, Chaos Raven, for 2,000 bits.
Woo!
Here's to my favorite streamers. Looking right. forward to the drinks.
So we have a monkey.
I don't think I'm supposed to kill the monkey.
Oh, who knows? It could be part of the puzzle.
Since
it is the only other living piece in this room.
Since Chaos Raven gave 2,000, does that mean their name is on a bottle?
It is indeed.
All right. Scott, perhaps take stock of your options before we do anything rash. What's something maybe that could make this monkey of value to us?
Yeah, have you ever looked through your abilities? Or your items? Have you ever taken stock of the things that you have acquired?
At this point, you may as well just tell him.
No. This is a puzzle. This is a
This is a puzzle,
but
I'm going to let him
If he wants to get to that boss...
This is a puzzle, but I'm going to let him bump into walls before I start going, ooh, did you notice
that? In fact, I'm
going to
apply a double drink rule for every time he fails the puzzle and dies.
God damn it, Nick.
No. We're doing this if he's not going to be fighting bosses.
Fair enough.
Is this like some like right that people can...
No, it's my fetish.
Oh, okay.
I mean... It's unfortunate because I learned the answer to this puzzle before I got here and was disappointed because I have no idea how long it would have taken me to put this together.
I did something like...
How do I give it the rice?
After I did what I did, I learned what I was supposed to do. I'm like, oh, that makes sense. But my way is also valid.
Like I said, I'm curious as to how yours work. Let me know if you want a hint, Scott. I won't just tell you, but I'll point you in
Here's
the right
thing.
Direction.
We're talking about mechanics I've never had to do. I have no idea what I'm supposed
You've
to do.
You've accidentally used this mechanic before. Not this specific one, but in the category.
Yes, and if I am to be correct, only accidentally.
Yeah, I don't think you've ever done this on purpose.
Should I just save us some time and say drink?
Actually, I mean,
No.
It's still an available option. Well, maybe not.
Oh, no, it's not. It's definitely not an available option.
Rafiki's pissed.
Fuck it.
He's alive.
It's still doable, I will say. Without the monkey, it is still doable.
Okay.
Because I did it without the monkey.
Then that makes me very interested in your method, because I assumed you just did the opposite.
But if you look through all of your equipment, maybe you can find something that
Perhaps
would assist you.
Something.
Maybe not even just the things you have equipped. Maybe something you've never used before at all.
Oh my Christ.
This is like in Jeopardy when like letters just keep filling in.
Come
and you're
on.
Like, oh fuck.
Interesting choice.
I mean, now I don't know what I'm going to do because the monkey's dead. So,
I mean, well, he didn't seem to give a shit about that, huh?
I wonder if you could sidestep through that. Do you have invincibility to get through there?
Who knows?
Yeah, they made sure that's like a wall.
Drake!
Could somebody hand me the bottle?
That would be me. I don't know why you asked somebody.
Because that's how I frame questions.
You should have said, can someone give me daddy?
Yes, yeah. Can somebody hand me daddy?
Give me daddy, I'm thirsty.
Daddy, I'm so thirsty.
Oh yeah, chat's pointing out you did invoke a double drink rule.
That's right. So put another one on. I'm not, that wasn't technically a death, was it? No.
That was really stupid.
Sorry, Team Rampage. Thanks, Scott, for handing me daddy. Good to know whenever I need a daddy, you'll be there for me, Scott.
I made that apparent. It's a double joke because I said apparent.
Oh, you know?
Ah.
That was a layer I hadn't even picked up on.
You had to make sure people got it.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, Grant, would you mind going and grabbing another bottle for us?
Sure.
While he navigates back to the serpent. And can I get a bottle of water, too, while you're out there?
Absolutely.
You could
ask me to do both things. I'm not on camera.
I could. You know what, Stefan? Would you mind grabbing us another bottle and me a bottle of water, perchance?
I will do that. I also want a bottle of water.
Thanks, Stefan.
Thank you. For making yourself useful.
Who is not Tyler, for everyone who
but
might
his middle name
still
is.
Think he was.
No, yeah, he's still Tyler. He's I just mean, not that Tyler. He's a different Tyler.
There you go. Now you're getting the fast path.
All right.
How are we doing this?
Let's see what you do now.
God damn it.
Camera's doing great work here.
Yeah. Truly a from camera. It's
really doing all the work here. When you think about it. Oh my God.
Remember, square button.
This camera so much. Yeah, I can't do it from here. And yeah. Also, beforehand, I didn't even need to hit the square button. I was just jumping.
Time it right. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm sure you can get a high jump to clear it.
All right. See how this works. Monkey didn't hear it. Maybe you're not close enough.
Hey, asshole.
Well, no, he's hearing it. He just doesn't care.
Does not care for the whistle.
Okay, maybe it's not the whistle.
Perhaps another tool is what we need. Maybe another kind of weaponry or style or skill or
some sort of art.
Type of move. Have you tried any cool hand signs?
I don't think he's picking up what you're putting down.
Jeopardy question for you, Nick. What is Rasengan Kage Bunshin no Jutsu?
I'd say it's some sort of...
And the fireball that Sasuke breathes. Hey!
Here we go.
Oh.
Intriguing.
Okay.
Now, do you remember how to trigger these?
Actually, you have no idea.
Okay.
I believe I walk up behind them.
If you do a stealth kill, and maybe a new prompt will show up when you stealth kill them.
Just keep tapping R1 when you're doing it. Just keep tapping the kill. There you go.
Look at that. He's your puppet now.
All right. You got Puppet Monkey. Now watch what he does. Let's see what he does.
What's Puppet Monkey about? Where's
he going?
Go?
Where'd he go? I don't know if you guys need one of these. Nope. Oh, there he goes. Oh, the snake has taken notice.
Snake's eyes are busy. Look at that!
Yay! Woo! So, do you want to know what I did?
Yes, please tell me.
I jumped up from that exact spot up to there, and I used the Mist Raven. It makes you invulnerable for a moment, so as the snake snapped back, I just ran past
it. That works perfect.
Oh.
Thank you, Hopeful Hyenas, for the bits.
Also. Yeah, by the way, I was never ever going to get that. Thank you for the hints. I've never used that before.
I know. Because you don't look at what you have.
Like there. You just grabbed that and
that
didn't
thing,
read
and
the
you
text.
Didn't even know what it does.
Who knows what that could be?
Could
Maybe
be
this is a
anything.
New weapon that would change your life. Maybe it's a key item that's just something you need to have in your inventory to trigger something. Who knows?
Could be so many things.
Where is it?
Thanks, Slushpuff, for the bits. I am pretty sure it's a key item.
There.
There you go.
The
look at that.
Persimmon like heart of Great Serpent. The Great Serpent is the god of the land, and the heart is believed to be where one spirit resides. While it looks much like a persimmon, in fact, this is a red viscera of a god. Apparently, denizens of the Sunken Valley worship the organs, believe they represent the deity itself.
See, look at that. You've got the heart of a god in your pocket, and you almost didn't notice.
Heart of a dead god.
Isn't that crazy?
Well, no getting out that way.
I'm pretty sure if I start stabbing it over and over, something's going to happen.
I'm pretty sure. It's just going to get angry.
He's a god.
Yeah, well, he's
sure?
a fucking bitch.
I'm also pretty sure that's a female snake.
Dumb bitch ass snake.
Scott, how could you?
Guy. All right, there.
Hey, look at that.
You
Wait.
Found your way up here.
We've looped
to a spot,
back around.
To a spot that you...
Have been before.
Not
I'm begging
this,
the ocean
not
of
this,
depth.
Not this part, though. You haven't gotten to it through this cave.
Yeah, yeah. Still.
So maybe there's stuff spot. That you can access from here that you can't from other parts of the cave.
I'm going to rest real quick.
Or not. That's fine. You can totally ignore that, but that's fine.
Wait, can I neck it back up there now?
Nope.
No. You're kidding.
It's too far of a drop.
God damn it.
FromSoft! Their level design is second to none.
And then what am I doing now?
They're bastards. Designed.
Well, now we're going to go back to the Sunken Valley in the Mibu village. Back at that shrine.
I actually don't know where you could go from there. I think I popped out of there when I got out.
You can get to the top of some of the Buddha heads.
I was going to say, I have a feeling you can look up and get somewhere because I very rarely do that.
Nibu village?
Yeah, it's where is it? It's further down past Harada Estate, I think.
Is it Ashina Depths?
Yes, Ashina Depths. That's what it is. Down Wedding Cave Door.
Woo!
Well, I'm gonna go edit that video now.
You go ahead and do that,
good.
Stefan.
Shout if you need something.
Will do.
Will do. Thank you. Get out of here,
Stefan.
Thank
Stefan. You so much, Stefan.
Yes, thank you for coming in tonight and dealing with our
if
bullshit.
If it isn't, please mute the tech desk mic would be the only thing I ask before you leave. It'll be the far left one.
Yeah, I already did.
Cool, thank you.
Thank you. You're wonderful. Where am I going?
Because sometimes sound travels over there weirdly. And
well, if you'd been paying attention.
I haven't.
Yeah, I know. Mm-hmm. You now smell different. So
you
go back in
like
that cave.
You smell like a...
some sort of incense.
Yes.
Do I smell like a bitch?
Yes.
Smell
Little
like a
Leonidas, thank you so much for the sub. Welcome to the team. Go ahead and hop in that little... Can't remember what the fuck that thing's called.
Palanquin.
Yeah.
Learned that word from
Steven Universe. Yep, I knew it.
Hate to admit that, but definitely...
Behold the strangest cutscene in this...
Yeah.
Entire game, probably.
I definitely caught on to what comes for you here, but had no idea what it would look like. I had guessed that I could see some of its belt. I was incorrect.
After this, I wanted to spend some time to see if you could see it elsewhere.
Because, yeah, if you hang out near this palanquin, because I got here before I smelled like incense, I kept looking up. You can see that rope dangling there, and I was like, oh. This is probably like some of his belt or something.
Some sort of claw machine.
Turns out...
It's just a bunch of rope.
Turns out it's a thing made of ropes.
Giant rope man. Big old log dong.
Hey, how's it going? I'm Groot. I get a clap for that every time I say it. Anyway, we're gonna go over to the... Oh,
shit.
Thank God this guy wasn't a boss.
Rope-a-dope.
The old rope-a-dope works every time.
I'm just gonna
I'm just kidding. I'm going to set you down over here, buddy.
Over here at the Fountainhead Palace. First stop.
Anyway.
Oh, I'm tired.
Ooh.
Oh,
you're a heavy motherfucker.
That takes a lot out of me.
It looks like he's made of root.
Maybe.
Kind of.
But the closer you get, it definitely looks like a rope.
I mean, it definitely is rope. That's his whole thing.
This might be a wooden rope.
He's a giant rope guy. But he looks like, when you look at his body, he kind of looks like he's made of root.
I am root.
But yeah, root.
That is probably the most confusing and odd cutscene in the entire game.
It is strange.
Yeah. It's never explained, Vatty.
I'm sure he's found the deep lore.
I like the sound of running on him, though. Yeah.
So I weirdly pay attention to the sound of footsteps in video games.
Yeah.
There are some games that I think have some very satisfying footstep sounds. Kingdom Hearts, in particular, I think Sora's shoes, while they look goofy as sin, fucking sound real satisfying when he walks around.
Teenage Rampage asking whose name's on the new bottle. We haven't quite cracked this one open yet, but for those wondering, it is Zykin.
Zykin!
Zykin.
I forgot this was right here. I thought you had to get in a little bit
first. It's right here.
Wow. Remember this?
Now they have 3 health bars.
Oh, hey, dude.
You fought their ghost.
Oh, hi. Okay. Oh, no, that's fine. I don't mind. I don't mind the fact that you're an asshole.
Maybe you should not be up here then.
Nah. I'm doing my best.
Hanging out on a tree.
Ah, damn it.
Remember this?
Yep, I do remember this.
This boss took me longer than I'd care to admit to beat.
Is this the secret boss?
No.
Right.
No.
I'm sorry.
No. No.
This is, as far as I know, a mandatory boss. Oh, that's a drink!
Yeah,
drink!
That's a drink. It's been a while. It's been a while.
Cosborne, are you comparing me to Tommy Tallarico?
I mean,
I haven't seen that guy in ages, but he liked video game music more than a lot of people, and I appreciated that. So maybe he and I are a kindred spirit.
The last time I saw him was at a video games live event, one of those concerts.
I was gonna say, I think
I'm pretty sure that's his baby.
Yeah, I think that's like his project. Which, again, like I said, I know he appreciates video game music, which has always been a passion of mine. That said, he made
nice
fun
dodge
of the Sonic Adventure 2 soundtrack on whatever rating show they had on G4, and that made me really mad. So,
what?
Judgment Day was there.
Judgment Day! Him and whoever it was.
Wait, what did he say about the Sonic?
Oh man, I don't remember the other guy.
It was either Sonic Adventure 2 or maybe it was Sonic Heroes. Either way, they have very similar soundtracks. And he's like, it's all 80s hair rock and I hate it. And I'm like, fuck you! Sonic's never had better music.
I don't know about
You're
better
really
music.
You're really good at dodging those, man.
Good work.
Also, hi, wife.
Oh, is Erica in there?
My wife's in the
Erica
chat.
Hi, Erica.
Kaiser's getting beaten up by a fat lady.
I really, really am. That laugh is chilling.
So I'll be honest, I've never actually fought the second phase of this boss. So I'll be interested to see what happens when we get to it.
And the fuck do you... What?
Oh, yeah.
I've always skipped it.
Forgot how you told me about that. Especially because this boss gave me a hell of a headache. Oh yeah, Erica was a frequent guest on Bloodborne. Has she tried this game yet?
She has not. Whew! I offered a few times when she'd walk in when I was streaming.
I know she liked Hitman. Apparently a new Hitman level just came
out. Apparently, yeah. So like some New York bank
probably gonna
thing.
Check that out this weekend. Drink! Depending on how I'm feeling after the stream, maybe even tonight.
Maybe we should bust out the game sometime tomorrow before Cash Fry or something.
Yeah.
I don't know. Hitman 2, Lost in New York.
Hitman 2 was a game that I really, really liked and then kind of totally forgot about, and really hope that he had it.
You know what? I think the fact that it wasn't episodic actually hurt it.
Yeah, me too.
Which is weird to say, because I'm like, oh man, I wish Hitman 1 was just a complete game, but the fact that it was episodic,
yeah, the fact
really...
that it kept coming out over time made me like keep checking in on it and reminding myself, like, yeah, this game fucking rules.
God damn it. I don't like that I'm having trouble with this chick. I feel like it really shouldn't be.
It's because you were just fighting Owl, and Owl has a completely different tempo.
Yeah, you are having to get used to a completely new pace.
Good block. Parry, I should say. Ha! Misjudged the reach.
I hate this fight, but I love this boss's like design.
I also like its theme. Like, I love that pan flute, whatever that flute is called. And I do think that this boss has significantly less stamina than the other one.
Probably because it only has three health bars. Probably because the other one only had two health bars.
Yeah.
That's what I was looking for.
Well, it only had one health bar.
Oh, that's right. It did only have one.
Drink!
Fuck.
Scott, don't feel bad. This boss took me forever.
Yeah, using tools is very useful on it.
Okay.
Remember, that's how you beat the last one, too. Good news is you use the rice, so after you die again, you could probably go back and get more rice.
Ooh.
Wait, I used the...
Yeah, you used the rice.
I didn't mean to do that.
Well, you did.
Hey, what's up?
And we do need to get rice a few times from her to proc the shit that we need, so...
Now that I know I didn't do.
Aw, damn it.
That's one thing that I'm really bad about in games, is I just hoard those special items and never use them, even to the detriment of like getting to the very end of the game and having not used them ever.
I think Resident Evil or something imbued in me a sense of never use anything unless you absolutely need it.
Yeah.
So I very rarely start using items until I'm like, man, I've been trying this boss for like 10 tries. And
maybe I'll try this.
Maybe I'll start using the sugar that I've been throwing away because I'm holding a max amount or whatever.
Yeah, I was definitely that way with, like, Resi 2, when it's like, hey, you have this ammo, but you only have so much.
I was so happy.
I'd wait till you get to, like, the boss where you need it.
I was so happy when Gumball actually made a reference to that.
Really?
Like, to...
Gumball.
Yeah, really.
Fantastic World or whatever?
Yeah, when it basically, they go into an RPG, and he's like, use a potion. I don't know, I've only got, like, 5 of them left. We're on the final boss.
Alright, phase 1 down.
Heyo.
Now let's see, because I've never fought this phase. I want to see what it actually does.
I will say Scott's already using my strat.
I'm just booking it.
Just if you keep moving, it's always attacking where you were. So as long as you're never where you were a couple seconds ago, you'll be fine.
I accidentally discovered how to bypass this part on my first playthrough, or on my first attempt at it, and never fought it since. Okay, so it just kind of does that, and then it goes back to normal. Okay,
yeah.
That's okay. That's more mundane than I thought it would be, honestly.
Nah, it just covers the place in the fog, and then has shadow clones show up and swing at you once, and then they kind of vanish. So it's just so long as you avoid them and wait for the real thing to reappear, you're fine.
I don't
remember how you skipped it, and I won't. We'll let Scott at least struggle a little bit before we.
Like, I'd skip it.
I mean, it's not a skip. It's like literally like a mechanic of this boss.
Yeah, just avoiding.
Oh, what?
Yeah.
Gumball officially ended recently, right, Scott?
Yeah.
Okay.
And it might get a movie.
Oh, and it pulls it out again. Okay.
Yeah. It can do this throughout this part.
Yeah, this seems annoying.
Does it not do it at all during the last health bar?
Nope.
Oh.
this last health bar, it has like a different mechanic, which is, in my opinion, more annoying.
I vaguely remember it, but I feel like this part was the part that gave me the most trouble. Once I got past this, the third health bar went down really quick, I feel like.
It just seems more annoying than anything. It's just like, okay, we have to run around and wait.
Yeah.
Yeah, actually, that's kind of dumb.
It was more I was not great at this part, so I kept dying.
Oh, the swing.
Just
swing,
like the main actual fight.
Oh, damn it.
Yeah, learning all of its tells is a pain, especially
for
the
third
phase. You are out of drinks,
just so you know.
I wouldn't use pellets unless you think you're
going
to beat
it. Oh, I remember what the third phase does now.
Yes. Third phase of this, we might actually need to bust out an item that we've never used before.
Very possible. And yeah, I definitely did get that third phase a few times. I did not beat it on my first try, now that I think about it.
The third phase was my bane.
I definitely feel like I was just not good at this fight in general, and the third phase was basically just a endurance more than anything, but it does get kind of fucky.
The thing that threw me off about the third phase is you have to be a lot more patient. Like, I'm used to playing so aggressively in this game.
Sato is asking what sake we are drinking. Does that have a brand or anything on it?
It is called Mura Mura.
Mura Mura.
Mura Mura. M-U-R-A, M-U-R-A. You know, like the JoJo.
Yeah.
Oh, that's Mura Mura.
It's a different Mura.
Is that a D?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. They pronounce their R's like D's, so.
Scott, have you played any of the Yakuza games?
No.
Your love of Japanese culture makes me adore them.
Goomba Stomp. Fuck! Bye, pellet.
Drink!
Let's go grab some rice.
No.
Well, honestly, you're going to want to go back to get rice as many times as you can because it's going to be a pain in the ass to get this thing. Do not make me grind it. I will kill you.
Scott, as my HR representative, I want you to know that an employee threatened another employee while I was present, and I just think you should know about it.
Grant, you should shut the fuck up!
Hey, Scott, as my HR representative, I feel like you should know that another employee threatened me.
You should go talk to Stefan about this, because...
I'm actually the head of HR, so...
You're the CEO,
yeah,
I guess.
You're not,
so, yeah, you're not HR
is not a, yeah, CEO's not allowed to be head of HR.
We're allowed to be, it's just... Morley,
hey, Slushbuff, thank you for the 1,500 bits, and here's for luck, guys. I have a meat grinder of a D&D session to go through. Good luck, man.
Best of luck.
Bountiful harvest. Here, take
the
rice.
Gohan.
I'm gonna go to the potty. You guys hold the fort down.
All right. God help you. I'm gonna go break that fucker's face.
Do it. Fountainhead Palace is where you're heading.
Boom, boom. Midnight GMR. This is an unhealthy work environment.
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Glad you caught on.
Yeah. La Volpa, thank you so much for the Prime sub. Welcome to the team. Welcome to the unhealthiest work environment on the internet.
Ow. Oh, fuck. Okay.
Yeah, their timing's a bit weird. But you're doing good, though. You're doing really good. Emperor Ors wants us wants to know how we feel about Star Versus ending. I never actually watched it.
And I fell out of it. I won't lie. That last season really lost me. Partially because the change in animation studios was really obvious. Ah, fuck. Damn it, I keep...
You keep trying to Mercuria them?
Yeah.
Yeah. Their Makiri tell is pretty obvious. And they do it, like, less often than the sweep.
Ah!
Like that. There's them. Yeah, there you go, buddy.
Fuck you.
Tap L1. Oh, never mind.
Wait, what would that have done?
It would have zipped you up into the trees and you could skip this.
Oh.
Too late now, though. They know you're there.
What did you say, L1?
Yeah, isn't that...
You mean L2? One?
Okay, it's been a while since I played. Fuck you. It doesn't matter. They know you're there now.
Ah, that was just really dumb.
But yeah, if you zip up into the trees, they lose track of you instantly. After you
I know,
beat their
that was
health
just,
bar.
I was just fucking around.
You can it is a good
Wait,
tool
so you
to
just hung
them.
Out you hung out in like the canopy and they just never hit you?
No, it's not even that. It's just after you kill their first phase, you zip up there and they lose track of you, you can stealth kill them.
Oh, that's right. Okay, yes. Hey, you told me about that.
Drink!
Oh, that's kind of fun.
It's a good way to save,
because I was going to say, I feel like I definitely tried drinks. That and then got hit out of the trees by the shadows.
So you got to do it pretty quickly.
Yeah, maybe I just wasn't fast enough, because I usually did, like, wail on her and then go in. Also, pass that bottle. I was going to say before the fight starts, but never mind. You can still pass it.
I'll pass it around the back. This is Canyon.
Oh, yeah. You can also pause, I guess.
Oh, right. Well, here you go, then.
It's usually so against FromSoft's ways. The first game of theirs, I think you can pause.
As far as I'm aware, you are correct.
Other than like Kingsfield and stuff, I never played those. First post Demon Souls.
First game of theirs I played was Dark Souls 2 for a Renegade.
Okay. That's a weird one to start on, but alright.
Second game I played was Bloodborne, which I thought was a lot better.
I would agree. As someone who still likes Dark Souls, Bloodborne is like twice as good.
Wilker Waff, we play this once a week, and it's Kaiser's playthrough.
Mm-hmm.
If we were passing around the controller, it would probably be less interesting.
Oh!
Ah,
didn't
damn
even
it.
Block that one.
Yeah,
or try to roll. There's the first life.
It's because I tried to parry it, and if you parry too late, then you just get fucking hit.
Whew!
God Jin Rai, thank you so much for the 17-month Prime resub. Happy to have you with us.
Oh. Shmoko asking if we have any plans to continue Tales of Vesperia. Currently, no, but if we have more chances to stream in the future, I would love to bust it out on random days. Heyo!
Drink! Vice Schnee 73, thank you for the 15 months, and Gogeta 166 for the 28. Hot damn! Thanks, guys.
Gogeta, right. Vegito.
Hmm?
All right. Gogeta, Vegito.
Gogeta. How many? 166 Gogetas. What could they fight?
Everyone.
I was a little surprised they never went Gogeta in the fucking Tournament of Power, and a little disappointed. If I'm gonna be honest.
A lot of cool things they could do that they don't do because
maybe,
that would
yeah.
be cool.
I do kind of like that Portaro were introduced and Goku and Vegeta specifically went, no.
I'm surprised nobody else on the field were like,
yeah,
no, we'll take up on that.
I actually thought that was going to be a Gohan Piccolo moment.
Oh, that would have been so cool.
But then they'd get to do something.
And we can't have that.
Toriyama can't have that.
Actually, they got to do something in the tournament. It just wasn't entertaining or interesting.
Okay, you
got to
jump that.
I know, man. I know what I got to do. I just suck at it.
The step. Yeah.
Ah, fucking A.
Even though he showed up to beat up Broly, Blue Vegito is still stronger than Blue Gogeta, correct?
I think it's they say that the Pitara is supposed to be stronger than regular fusion, or at least that's what the Kai said.
Yeah, that was the lore we were originally given on it. That said, if Goku and Vegeta improved so much since when they were Vegito, that Gogeta is now stronger. Oh!
Drink! Yeah, trying to use that when they're doing an attack with momentum won't stop it.
Alright, you bitch.
Also, if the Broly movie is to be canon, then Goku have to teach Vegeta the fusion dance there?
Oh, good point. Well, actually, he might have known it through, like, osmosis, maybe?
I mean, he knew of it, but
They did spend time practicing it.
Yeah, they imply that he had to be taught it
Did you forget that it could hit you there?
It's got a very big...
I thought maybe if I went up into the trees immediately...
Is the weapon that the corrupted monk is using a spear, or is that decidedly something else
that
and not just a subdivision of spear?
Yeah.
But a naginata is not a kind of spear, it is its own thing, correct? Yeah.
It is a type of pole arm, though.
Okay.
It's basically like a very... It's a scimitar at the end
of...
So pole
arm is the category, and spear and naginatas are just two different pole arms.
Yes. Okay. A naginata is like a sword at the end of a pole, or at the end of a stick.
Okay. I think
in this case, kind of a scimitar type thing.
Then I think that's my preference to spears. I used to think I loved spears. I think I love pole arms.
Yeah, because it's like there's...
Because spears are more of a thrust, and I'm less into that.
Yeah, spears, tridents, naginatas, halberts, all fall under the category of pole arm.
Gotcha. Okay. I think I just did not know the keyword pole arm. When you're away from an opponent doing a combo, it just looks silly.
I know, right?
Take that air!
Booker Woff with a 500.
Yo!
Have fun playing Kaiser. Hope you don't lose your sanity. I would love to stay and watch, but it's zero dark 30. And here, and I gotta work at 8 a.m. Well, have a good night, dude.
Go to sleep.
Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.
And have a good day at work.
Hope your dreams are sweet.
Somewhere in Western Europe.
Thank you, Raiwanu Chiha.
Eastern Europe.
Picking up on what I was specifically asking. Vegito during the Goku Black arc versus Gogeta in the Broly fight.
Been through more training since then.
I was gonna
say
they've improved since then. So is that improvement enough to make it
not fast enough? That and wrong tree branch, maybe.
You need to be like really high up.
Yeah, it's like zipping around, and then they lose track of you, and then you can like hit them in the head. But I think they know you're there, so.
Cause yeah, you can.
I don't know. I never had issue with it for whatever reason.
It might be something that was a thing, and then they might have patched out.
I can't imagine them patching that out. It's weird. I don't know. It has been a bit.
Because I don't think that was intentional.
Maybe.
I think you are supposed to try. Because
you can still do all the other exploits to this boss that you could on the other one, like throwing the fucking dust in its face and then firecrackering until it just gives up on life.
Yeah. I was going to say, I don't think that's an exploit, but then, yes, continuing that, yes, it is.
Oh, somebody said they patched it. Oh, never mind.
Because, yeah, that is definitely, I mean, yeah, it's really cheesy to dust.
Well, you got phase two down anyway. Nice.
But yeah,
if I may make a suggestion, back up. Pause real quick, actually, because you're going to need this. Go to your quick items. Go to a blank spot. And let's add us some pacifying agent.
Oh, yeah.
This is something we've never used before, but you're going to need it.
When you get terrored, use this to get rid of it.
Okay.
Nice dodge.
Calamity 2007 asking, why patch exploits for a single player game? I can understand that sentiment, but at the same time, that's unfortunate.
You gotta revive at least. You still have pellets.
I feel like this...
Oh, never mind. The rice is still working.
I do feel like this phase takes more damage, but I could be imagining that.
I think it does too, actually, now that we're looking at it. Holy shit, how do you keep avoiding that?
Yeah, if you stay close, that vomit doesn't hit.
That's so bizarre.
Yeah,
I'm
no,
so confused
that
right now.
Is not a hitbox. It's not until after the hand. So that's why I didn't have much trouble with this. I never backed off.
Okay, yeah, that was my problem. I kept backing off. You have healing pellets if you need them.
That wasn't
no, no,
it.
No, no,
that
no,
was
no.
a pacifying agent, which... Woo!
No.
Wrong timing.
No,
bad,
God
bad,
damn
bad,
it!
Bad timing, but good time for a drink! You were absolutely dominating it, though. Mm-hmm. That third phase killed me, like,
on top of that,
close
Scott,
to a dozen times.
I have such
times.
Confidence, I'm taking...
It's right in front of you. Oh, wait.
I'm playing the game.
Oh, what game?
I was
game?
Going to ask you to fill me up while I played. Wow. You know what? No, I'm...
No,
yeah,
you,
I, yeah,
he
I'm
knows
sticking,
what he
I'm
meant.
I'm sticking way to that, actually.
Guyver XMKII, thank you for the 3,000 bits. I managed to catch... Is this what you just read?
No, I did not read that. So sorry if it went by. I wasn't reading it.
Yeah, they haven't managed to catch a stream in a bit, but we're happy to have you. Thanks so much, dude. Holy shit. Sam Lionheart, thank you so much for gifting a sub to Nightbot. Nightbot,
yo!
Happy to keep you a part of the team, courtesy of Sam Lionheart.
Thanks, Nightbot.
Oh, I hate you so much. I hate you, bitch.
Okay, if they patched out the phase 2 exploit, I feel like...
I have a feeling they phased out the patch, or the phase 3.
Well...
If it was a thing.
I feel like if they did patch that out, I think they made this thing take more stamina damage, because I feel like it's taking a lot more than when I fought it.
Possible. Might also just have more physical damage, and I think that applies more.
Maybe.
Posture.
Thirsty Tripod. It's a great name. Thanks so much for the second month resub.
A lot of people are saying the phase 2 exploit that you used still worked.
Top left branch. Yep. That's what I thought. The highest branch. The best branch.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Also, Dark Lord of Swords says that's a Nagamaki. 50-50 blade and hilt. Naginata is spear, IMO. I don't know the difference.
The
I
more you know.
I won't argue.
Actually, a Naginata does have a blade at the tip. Well, this is more of a... Oh, my God. I'm looking for the symbol, not the fucking...
Not at the animation?
Yeah.
Yeah, see the whole picture.
It's one of those I started listening for the sound more than the picture. If I heard the... I knew I had to just look at what they were doing.
Ah, that's a good point.
Oh! Drink!
Who's playing? I'm playing. But I ain't playing. I ain't fucking playing.
Yeah.
Let's go get more rice.
Scott is not playing. He's being serious. Grab that rice.
More rice.
I can't
remember how many times you have to die between rice.
I definitely didn't do that.
There's also another thing we need to give her, but I can't remember what area. Wait, no. I remember exactly where you have to go to get it. That's
apparently, it. Naginata has longer blade than shaft, or more blade than shaft than this does.
She's getting sleepy.
Gohan.
Gohan.
Proper swallowing rice.
Make sure
God damn it,
to
bitch. She still hasn't even asked for the fruit yet.
Make sure to save the rice before you swallow it.
I didn't do whatever you're trying to do with this, not Lord.
Young the divine child.
Yeah, this other divine child.
The divine child.
This divine little girl.
Hey, did either of you guys see the first season of Happy on Sci-Fi?
No.
I did not.
I'm watching the second season. It's not as good.
Was the first season good, though?
First season is a mixed bag, but it's mostly good. And the bad stuff is just me.
That's kind of how I felt about Westworld. I thought the first season was amazing, and the second season was pretty bland up until, like, the last maybe three episodes.
I feel like this is a common thing, but since we're talking about shows that started good, but maybe later iterations were significantly more poor. Arrested Development. I couldn't sit through the first Netflix season, and apparently there's been more since then, and I don't think I'm ever going back.
I never actually enjoyed that show to begin with.
Really?
To be honest. Yeah.
That surprises me, actually.
It never got me.
I actually enjoyed it, but I just never had a way to watch it after I watched the first couple of episodes.
There are just certain comedies where, for whatever reason, they just don't jive with me.
Yeah, I'm not gonna.
I'm the same way with Brooklyn Nine-Nine, actually.
Okay, that's ridiculous, and
I don't
you're wrong.
Know. I didn't like The Good Place. I didn't like Brooklyn Nine-Nine, but I loved Parks and Rec.
I ended up liking The Good Place. I didn't think I would, and I kind of watched
The Good
it
Place is fucking
really
fantastic.
Yeah, Good Place was a lot better than I thought it would be.
There are certain things that just don't jive with me.
I can get The Good Place way more than Arrested Development, though. Good Place. Oh, Stefan's walking in.
He has a feeling.
I have a feeling he's got opinions on something we've said.
Yes.
Now, yeah, both those shows are created by a guy named Mike Shore, or at least partially created by it.
Wait, okay. Arrested Development and Good Place?
No, not Arrested Development. Brooklyn Nine-Nine
okay.
and The Good Place.
All right. Okay.
Yeah.
That makes more sense.
There is some cross-pollination, I think, between Arrested Development and The Good Place. I don't know what it is. I could be wrong, though. No, that's Community and Arrested Development. They both were directed by the Russo brothers.
Yeah, if you target them, target the real one. You can see the real one. Right there. Up there. Jump. Nope. Look at them! Target them! What are you doing?
You have to target them!
Oh.
I see what you're saying.
Doing phase two.
I see what you're saying. I see what you're saying.
But you didn't do it!
Well, yeah, I see what you're saying now!
But okay, Stefan, you were saying there's some cross-pollination between those shows?
I think I was getting mixed up with Community, which Community and Arrested Development both have the Russo brothers as directors.
Gotcha.
It makes sense that Grant would like The Good Place because it's if Lost was a comedy.
Yes, it is very much what if Lost was a comedy.
And that's
I can definitely see that
and
approach.
And that's because Mike Shore actually talked to one of the lead writers of Lost while creating that comedy.
That's okay. That makes a lot of sense. See, I binged it all on Netflix like last month and like watched it all over the course of maybe a week. And to me, it felt like a show that started off with one idea, and then by the time season two came around, they're like, we need another idea, and kind of ran with it.
It's a show that, like, I think they're on their last season now, because they're like, no, this is a finite show, we're not going to
I feel like I had
forever.
Heard it got canceled after the second season, and the third season was like a surprise, like, oh, thank God, we're getting another chance to actually end this.
I don't know, I think NBC's holding on to anything they have for dear life, because they don't have any TGIF shit anymore.
Very possible, I've not been paying attention to.
Yeah!
That's how you do it.
That's really cool, I had no idea that was possible. That would have made this fight so much fucking for me. Jesus Christ.
It really does.
Holy shit.
It sounds like, Nick, you may not be a Mike Shore guy.
It seems that way.
He created Parks and Rec.
I did like Parks and Rec.
You like Parks and Rec.
I like Parks and Rec a lot.
He was also a part of The Office.
And I like The Office, too.
Okay.
I think The Office is good.
That's
I guess it's just those shows that like just don't jive with me for whatever reason.
Arrested Development, I definitely think, takes a little bit. Like, it's kind of once you realize, I don't know.
I love the shit out of Arrested Development, even the weaker last two seasons.
Once I started the Netflix ones, I was like, this feels...
It's different.
Yeah, I was not into
no!
it.
No! But I still have a life!
Oh, yeah. I almost
You're on
the
pacifying agent, by the way, not a healing item.
Yeah, I don't have any healing items!
Oh, you used up all your pellets?
Yes!
That sucks.
What? No, don't jump. What the fuck?
Now jump.
Strike! Oh my god. Did you buy a lot of that? That's a Junmai Daiginjo? Oh
yeah.
No. Junmai Ginjo, not Daiginjo.
Something Gaijin what?
I said get out
Daiginjo.
Of here,
Daiginjo.
Apparently this company's Daiginjo is not very good. Tastes too much like alcohol. According to the helpful person at the Total Wine that I talked to.
Osake is the Japanese word for alcohol, but sake is the word for rice wine.
Oh, sake.
My face is a little red. Yes, I have been outside a lot, so I'm definitely going to be tanner than anybody else on the couch.
Yeah, it's been happening to me too, and I'm so used to being the pale person.
Yeah, but you walk to the office though,
yeah,
right?
I've been walking outside though, so I've been getting
What's
tan.
What's happening to this kid?
Yeah, she's so tired. She's tired of producing rice.
Give me a persimmon.
Do you have any persimmons?
I don't have a persimmon, but I have something that looks like a persimmon.
How do you know? Why don't you talk to her? See if you have one. Maybe you accidentally picked one up. Oh, never mind. I know where to find one, though. God damn it.
Oh, we don't have the persimmon either?
No.
Gotta get the fruit. Gotta get the fruit!
I need to go to Senpo Temple.
Okay, good. I did remember where it was. I'm pretty sure
that's... Senpo Temple, Mount Kongo. Wait, no. Further. My bad. Oh, there's an area here that we need to go to anyway. Because there's another thing you need to grab.
Thanks, Char, for the 100 bits. There's a problem with FromSoft games and their endings. Like, usually the best ending is one that's not anything anyone's going to naturally run into.
Although this one actually gives you a lot more hints than
typical. All right, so am I doing anything here?
Also, I feel like this game in particular, and I don't know as much about it, so maybe that's why it feels this way to me.
To the left.
But I feel like this one has more specific stuff for its ending than other games do.
Down there in stealth.
For Bloodborne, it wasn't that hard, and... Dark Souls. I don't remember.
Make sure you have
you could miss.
Puppeteer equipped.
I do.
Okay, then backstab that, bro.
Yeah, Bloodborne's like the big offender of
the
like
dude, the one that's Bloodborne there, the one with the hat. You can see him. He's right the fuck there.
Oh shit! Yeah.
See the little rat?
Am I behind him?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. He's looking over the canyon. That's a trivia puppet. That said, to finish what I came in here for. Nick, I don't totally disagree with you when it comes to Brooklyn Nine-Nine in that I like every episode. I just don't love any of them.
Yeah, okay.
For me, it's fair. Like it's consistent, but it's not the best thing I've ever seen ever.
I've seen clips that I've enjoyed, but I just can't enjoy whole episodes.
Yeah, I was going to say, I think I've seen definitely scenes and like heard concepts from it that I'm like,
so now
great.
We're going to go all the way around the temple.
Yeah. But thank you, Stefan. You can go back to editing.
Yeah, I'm gonna finish that edit.
Pretty sure we can teleport there via the thingies.
And that won't result in
anything? He will not leave.
You'll be fine.
So, back up.
Back up. And, oh, what?
Because, the way I spoiled myself on the earlier thing with the snake.
Get closer to the other wall.
Yeah,
there you go.
Yeah.
Was I can't remember what I was watching, but it was something. It was like some sort of guide for a boss, and then it gets to something about the whistle. And it's like, and then you get the whistle, which is what you can use for this and this. I immediately went, oh, apparently that's how I do that.
You need to jump off that wall.
You mean this one?
Yes, but on the side of it.
Do you,
so you,
do you
go
see
around.
The other ledge there? Whoop. There you go.
There you go. Now you're learning how to traverse.
Look at that.
And we're only how many episodes in?
Actually, you know what? That's pretty good. I don't think I ever figured that.
Shut up, episodes in. Nick.
Yo, 5,000 bits from EPAM. Holy shit.
Oh, damn. Every time you see something.
Oh, something about Stefan.
Here, let me run back there.
Yeah, because that's a lot of bits there. Senpo, Mount Kongo. Do down a little more. There. Temple grounds.
Hi.
Yo, Epam saying, I think he left the room already, but next time you see Stefan, tell him he's swell.
No.
Stefan!
No.
Epam says you're swell!
Oh, God damn it.
Epam loves you, Stefan!
Yeah, Epam is in love with Stefan.
Thanks!
He says thanks.
He says thanks.
Alright, so...
Oh, jeez.
That's gonna sound great.
That did sound... I hate
so,
you.
So, turn. Keep looking. We're looking for a... Look up. And around... That's why I wish I... It's around here somewhere. I remember this.
Oh, we're looking for...
We're looking for that... that
kite?
Kite.
Did you forget the word kite?
Yes, I did. I'm drunk. Shut up.
Oh,
do you guys ever have a
oh,
kite?
Oh, no, this is the wrong place. My bad.
Ah, you dumb bitch!
No, fuck you.
You ever go fly a kite?
Yeah, I used to a lot when I was a kid.
Yeah?
Yeah.
We had a soccer field that my grandpa and I would go to, and we flew kites. It's fun.
Where the fuck are you supposed to go? Maybe you do have to run all the way.
I was gonna say, I think you have to actually walk deeper in.
Yeah, you do. You have to walk through it. Because I don't think we unlocked the one that we needed.
Ha 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 ha.
Don't Can both that. Of you guys roll your R's?
Yes.
Fernando.
I learned how to
Fernando
roll my R's.
Fernando Rodriguez.
I learned how to roll my R's not through trying to roll my R's, but through trying to make machine gun sounds as a kid, and started going was like my machine gun.
That's a good
go-to.
Starting point for it. So yeah, we have to go.
That's pretty cute.
And then when people were like, "Do you know how to roll your R's?" It's when you go, hrr, I was like, "Oh man, it's like when I go," but I just put
left
vocal cords to it, so hrr.
Straight out that way. Pretty much ignore everybody here because the XP they give isn't worth it, and they don't have anything. So just stick to the treetops if you're able, and then run past them if you can't.
I'm glad I can roll my R's because it gives me a lot of versatility with my creature sounds.
Oh. No, I can get that. I never thought about that.
You know, yeah. I never talk about voicing Icarus, but Icarus is a lot of fun.
Oh, Tyler. You did the Icarus sounds? I didn't know
behind
that.
Behind you and up.
But that does make
other
perfect
way.
Sense knowing you.
Into that house.
Yeah, there's like a little
thing
you
gotta get into.
There's like a little hole in the roof.
Look for green dots. If you see a green dot.
You done zit before, but it's been
a
second.
I was just trying to get some distance from those guys so
I
could scope
the
place. I
don't know
if he did.
I think I ran through this.
Yo, Full Metal Gary knows what's up. He was making
ignore,
machine gun sounds.
Ignore everything. Because
kill them bugs! Okay. We gotta exterminate this place! Empty it out!
Yeah, this is dumb. Okay. No, I don't stop.
You don't stop.
Don't stop.
In here and to the left. There's a window.
No.
To the left, there's a window.
It was...
You sound so
it was
frustrated. Yes,
it was Cat Dog that had like the security system that was like exterminate and destroy, right? Chat
this way.
I'm yes. asking that because I'm guessing tree. My co-hosts don't know.
Man, if this shit bugs you so much, I do not mind giving this to you.
I asked.
No, you didn't.
I
you
fucking did.
He did initially, but I'm saying I think this is fun. Fine, Scott. Two-thirds of the couch are okay with the progression.
And that is why I am doing what I'm doing and trying to keep as zen about it as possible.
Yes,
and it
exactly.
is a very paper-thin Relax. Veil.
All right, where am I going from here? Down there?
Yes.
Okay.
When you realize the draw here is more seeing someone struggle and getting drunk than beating a game. If people want
to
see...
At the same time, I think we'd like to beat it at some point.
No, I mean, you'd love to beat it at some point. You don't just wait forever. That's why we had two episodes stuck on Owl and not three.
I think we had three.
We had three episodes on Owl, not four.
We had two episodes being stuck on Owl and one episode without getting beaten.
Yeah,
there we go. Now we can
You got to
talk
Owl
to that
on
guy.
One episode. You were trapped on him for two, and then you beat him on the fourth.
It's our friend, the Black Hat Badger. I don't think we ever bought his hat. Never mind. I guess he doesn't want to sell it to us.
Thanks, Black Badger.
Now
you can warp here whenever.
Yeah.
Gonna rest real quick. Doesn't want to sell it to us? Then what do we do?
I honestly think you'll be able to find it at some point. Don't worry about it. Either that or we did buy it. It's whatever. Behind you.
Anyway, I'm gonna go back to Washington Castle. You should probably watch your back if you get there. Hint, hint, hint.
Well, there's nothing interesting over here.
No, but out here there might be.
Meeboo.
Oh, look, it's our friend. It's down there somewhere, maybe.
Oh, yeah, that's right. This. Perhaps go to the end of that post.
Of the end of that log once you're done checking back here.
There's
nothing there.
Just gonna walk out to the end of this log.
And look down.
And looking
look,
down.
Look, it's our friend.
Ooh, remember that snake that was harassing
can you
on the mountain?
Maybe lock onto something? Oh, look at that.
That's weird.
Oh my god, can I?
Who knows
you know
if you
what?
Can do any
you can
sort
only
of
try.
Stealth attack. Oh.
If you maybe leapt out a little further, god damn it!
That was great. 10 out of 10. Would do again. There we go.
Mm. So, fun fact, this snake and that other snake are different snakes.
Yeah.
Because this one has an injured eye. There you go. Now you have the fresh one.
Now you've got a heart right out of the gate.
Damn.
Is this the persimmon she needs?
Fuck. No, it is not, in fact.
I couldn't remember if there was an actual
there
persimmon.
There is an actual persimmon. Okay.
Gal, that snake might not be doing something now, but it definitely killed us earlier. Nice!
Oh, good work. Okay.
You can dive now. Ooh. I mean, you can check out what's under this water. Never been here before.
That's a glowy green thing.
There is a whole bunch of shit underwater that we have not gone back to collect, frankly.
Frankly.
I don't think I ever noticed that the...
You say frankly a lot.
That the glowing
yellow
becomes...
It's one of the 100-something words in my repertoire.
That it becomes green underwater. That's...
Okay.
What with yellow plus blue and all?
Huh?
Something saw you. You might not want to fight, but it saw you. Those treasure carp, they don't like fighting.
Yeah, they run away.
They just like giving you red scales that give you something. I'm not entirely sure.
They let you unlock things.
Nice. That'll get you a view.
No, it won't. Those are just the angry fish.
Oh.
The treasure carp flee.
Never mind.
They're like the crystal lizards and shit.
Yeah.
And you have to sprint after them or else they disappear. They're honestly kind of a pain in the dick to hunt, especially in some larger water spaces.
I like this because this gives me the rare opportunity for you to be the expert in a FromSoft game to me, and I like it.
Yeah, fair enough. There's one. Good work.
Got
him. Dead.
Get fucking dead, please. Thank you. Red sugar. Love that red sugar.
Different I did not realize different. How quickly they respawn. There it goes. Can't keep swinging. There
oh, nice. I didn't think you got it.
I shouldn't have. Let's be honest.
I would have said you missed it.
All right.
Well, the thing was stupid and swam into a wall, so...
Like an
if
idiot,
I
it
designed
gets what...
this game...
Alright, how do I get out of here?
It's that way. That way is your beacon of teleportation.
I like how you say that way. Like, it actually indicates a
I'm
direction.
Pointing.
Motherfucker, you're pointing at a screen, you dipshit!
Yeah, at a screen, the direction you are going.
Has there been... So we've all played some stealthy games where they've had like a tailing segment where you have to stay close but not too far, but not too close.
Travel.
Has there has there ever been a game that did that well? I don't think I've ever played a game with a stealth tailing segment that I've been like, awesome, that was a great game.
Yeah, no, probably not.
I remember doing it in Metal Gear and it sucked there. I remember doing it in Resident Evil or something and it sucked there. I've done it in other games. Assassin's Creed sucked there. I don't think that concept, I think it's a cool concept. I don't think it's ever been fun.
Yeah, it's bad in pretty much every game.
I would say that along with, like, escort missions.
Like, stealth following
You're raising your hand
things.
There.
Stefan,
I'm just going to get you the person.
Oh, wait, Stefan, walk back in. Hold
no,
on.
No, where am I going?
Motherfucker. I'm going no. to the bathroom.
Get to that Simpo Temple.
Wait, you were only driving this out longer.
It's down a hill.
Fucking.
I can't remember what we're headed towards, but hey, man, I'll try to lead you.
I have feelings about stealth games.
Okay,
you know
go ahead, Stefan.
No, you're going to be wrong.
Tell me about stealth games, Stefan. Stealth, Steph.
Temporarily take Nick's place here.
All right, you're going to have to talk loud because his voice is naturally louder than yours.
I can talk loud.
Okay, good.
So, stealth games. I really, really, really like stealth games, actually.
Okay.
Okay. I was expecting that you hated them, and I was going to be like, oh, no.
Nah, man. When stealth
opinion.
Is done great, it's some of my favorite gaming experiences. Particularly, if you want to play a good stealth game, the Dishonored series is really good.
I can vouch for that as someone who doesn't like stealth games, but thought Dishonored was pretty good.
Also, yeah, there is obviously Metal Gear. Deus Ex actually is a game that's, I think, better played as a stealth game than any other kind of game.
Definitely heard that before. Never played it, but I've frequently heard stealth is the way to play it.
And Hitman is kind of just a puzzle game. It's not necessarily a stealth game.
Yeah.
Especially
in recent patches where they made you much more
And yes, Splinter, as someone in the chat also mentioned, Splinter Cell, that series mostly has good stealth games. Mostly.
But I'm specifically asking for tailing missions. Missions where you gotta stay not so far, but not so close.
Ah, okay, so for that kind of thing, trying to think. Hitman actually, I think, has kind of done that best. Because you have to sort of...
I've only played recent ones, so if it was an earlier one, I didn't experience it.
Well, that's kind of all that Hitman games are, when you think about
it. Yeah, you can't be too close. Yeah. Okay, I'll accept that.
Like, and the way they handle those mechanics is actually the best way, I think, to try and handle those mechanics.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I can take that.
But yeah, most games, it is an afterthought when they do it.
Yeah.
I haven't played a stealth game proper since Metal Gear Solid 3.
Wow.
Yeah. Okay. Which I love Metal Gear
great.
Solid 3.
Yeah, I've replayed that game more than most games.
Shit, I forget where the... where's the goddamn...
What are you looking for? You're going to have to describe it before I can
I'm looking for the shrine.
Like the nearest shrine to get to?
Yeah.
I think it might be behind you.
Fuck.
I think you are going actively away from it. If I had to guess. Because I think it's kind of like back this way and just up a hill.
But yeah, I would say tailing missions, if a game is not tailored to stealth and it's tailored more as an action game, usually it's a very boring detour rather than a well-handled mechanic.
What would you say is the best stealth game, Stefan?
The best stealth game?
I'm trying to make this comfortable for me and better for Sam. Anyway.
The best stealth game I played, Metal Gear Solid 3 is definitely high up there. In terms of just gameplay, I actually love Metal Gear Solid V. Technically... You can say 5, but apparently Hideo Kojima's like, no, it's V.
Oh, he wants it pronounced it. Okay.
And there's reasons. But I think Dishonored is actually my favorite stealth series.
Okay.
I really hope they make more Dishonored.
I think I played the first mission in Dishonored and then put it down. It's one that I should probably maybe someday go back to if they ever re-release it somewhere that I can play on a modern console.
I believe there is a remaster Dishonored for like PS4 and whatnot.
Okay.
I mostly play them on PC, but for like quick saving stuff because I save scum a bit.
You coward.
I think you can go up from there. I might be wrong, Scott. Also, if you want the actual fastest way to get to a shrine, fucking use your teleporter item.
God damn you.
Yeah.
I could have remembered that.
Just
too.
Go ahead and use that.
And now I'm going to, after saying my piece, I'm going to cede the seat back to Nick.
All right, see you later. Dishonored's a great stealth game. You heard it here first from Stefan. No one's ever told you that before. Bye, Stefan. Thanks.
You know what's a good stealth game? Dishonored.
Oh, wow. Thanks, Nick. That's an opinion I've never heard before.
Hey, what's my freaking...
No, you got to go over... You're in key items right now. You need to go to a usable one. Then down.
Did you get
home,
it?
The home thing.
It's at the very bottom, the bone.
He definitely got something under the water there. I don't know if that's what you were trying to lead him to, but he went underwater and grabbed something.
I want to apologize real quick. I think I'm just having kind of a bad day here. And
no, you're fine.
I admittedly have a very short fuse right now. And between the alcohol and that, I feel like I'm just a little bit more irritable than I should be.
Making it a little more tense, maybe?
Yeah.
You know, while you've been irritable, I've been laughing at it.
Yeah,
so.
No, it's good. Yeah.
As long as it's entertaining.
None of us have been actually upset. Don't worry about
close to offended.
Yeah. Like, because, hey, as someone who has watched people play games that I know
down that
fairly
hill
well,
next to you there.
I've certainly known the feeling of like, oh, come on, just get there. But... as someone who doesn't know this as well and realizing it from that perspective of an audience member, I think it's kind of fun to be like trying to figure it out as they're watching it. But I can also absolutely get the perspective of, I know where he has to go and it's really annoying.
It's just one of those things where it's like, I want to like keep progression going and this is all a very side thing.
Yes.
Is like, I guess I'm coming from.
It's unimportant, so it's not necessary.
And it's all incredibly convoluted. Like, this isn't even the most convoluted it gets.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm totally open to you being
is
like...
Is that it?
Yes. That's a persimmon.
You got the persimmon! Well, hey, he's got the item he needs. He now knows that if he teleports back, he's got it.
Yes.
But just to emphasize and ease your conscience, neither of us have been having a bad time, I would say.
I don't care.
At least I certainly haven't. Oh, no!
Oh, okay. All right. Well, that's good to know. I'm glad to know that. So, in the future, when I use it,
Yeah, no, it does not protect you.
Yeah, it's also not an insta thing.
Definitely have to sit down, mumble a prayer, and then you teleport. Yeah.
If you get up in that tree, you'd probably be safe.
You'd definitely be safe in the tree. You might be safe now.
You can't use it when you're moving.
Yeah, you apparently were moving as you pressed it, so.
You're still moving.
There. I'm not moving anymore. I don't care.
Just somewhere. Now, I have to
Funny enough, you were close enough to the idol that you probably just... It might have actually been faster to get to it.
Fuck's given, like, very little. Mostly because I am drunk enough to where it would have probably been an issue just finding the goddamn thing. Is anyone excited for Mario Maker 2? I don't know. I've never played 1.
I'm intrigued, but I'm not, like, excited. Like, I might not come in for tomorrow's cash fry for it. It's just not something that, like, drives me, you know?
Yeah. Let's see. Travel to... actually, Inner Sanctum?
No.
What? With the
persimmon? Yeah. Never mind. You want to give her the persimmon. Sorry.
Yay. Bop. Bop, bop. All right, cool.
Bitch, eat this fruit. Keep it!
Yeah, it wasn't a fucking problem. It was just a fucking...
Yeah, I just had to run through a field of ghosts. And angry monkeys.
Spits it out into your hand.
Here, now you can have rice. Thank you for the fruit. Now we have to go talk to the Kuro.
The crow?
The crow. To give him that rice that she wants you to give him.
Did we beat the fucking...
No. Kuro's, like, important places. Kuro's room.
Crow's room.
Ah.
So I've had fucking JoJo open. I've had JoJo on the brain lately.
You have?
Yeah, like crazy. Mostly because, you know, part five's going and part five is my, like, my second least favorite part, but it's been on my mind a lot. So
your second least favorite part makes it on your mind?
I mean, it's still JoJo,
I guess. How many parts are they up to, like, in the manga?
In the manga? What part are they on? I think they're on part 8. No, they're on part 9.
Go talk to
boy. Oh, wait, 8. Never mind. Because 5, 6, 7.
Boy.
Yeah. Boy.
Boy.
I brought rice.
Here, take the rice. Yes, it's rice.
Yes, Christ.
Soka.
I'll eat anything.
I'm gonna make some. Nah, man, I just eat handfuls of dry rice.
He
needs to make it. It's gonna take him a sec.
Alright. Then you know what we're gonna do?
We're gonna go fight that thing again.
We're gonna go fight the fucking bitch again.
You should go kill it.
I am. I'll fucking kill it. Just watch.
I hope so.
Just fucking watch.
It needs to die.
It must die.
So you can get to probably the most frustrating area in the game.
So I haven't played... I haven't read any of part 8, but it looks awful. It looks really fucking bad. I'm sorry. And it might actually be good, like the story itself, but the, oh my god, the art looks so bad. I'm sorry. I'm a JoJo fan, and I don't know what to tell you.
Big, beefy, greasy men.
No, non-part eight.
Oh. All right, so we got some rice to give to Kuro, and we gave the rice to Kuro.
Did anything happen?
He's gonna make us something with it.
Ooh. I didn't miss a drink or anything, right?
No.
Okay.
That was a stand. That was a jump.
Yeah, I need enough. Wait. Part six is Jolene. Part seven is Steel Ball Run. Part eight is JoJo Leon. And I'm sorry, but the art for JoJo Leon looks really, really bad.
I didn't even know there was a part eight. Is that new?
It's in the manga, I guess.
Yep.
Gotta jump those.
Yep. So I definitely heard of Steel Ball Run, but I have not heard this new name.
Yeah, Steel Ball Run is apparently very good. And I've read part seven and or part six, and I am.
I don't know what the anime is going to use for the ending theme for part six, but I really hope it's. I know there's a song. I can't remember who it's from. But some famous musical artist that's just called Jolene, and I really hope that's what they use.
Oh yeah.
Jolene.
Dolly Parton.
Yeah, it's Dolly Parton. Thank you. Knew it was some famous woman, but could not remember who.
So saith Meru Meru.
I will believe you, Meru Meru. I think you're right, because it does sound like a Dolly Parton song when I think of it. Part four got me, like, back into JoJo. Part five is fine, but part four I definitely think is better. And I don't think
I agree.
I don't think that's an unpopular.
Well, part four is my favorite, flat out.
I'm getting the vibe that a lot of people's favorite is part four, because it is also mine.
I liked a lot of things about Not High Enough. Wrong branch.
I think you were within the vision cone.
You're also on the wrong branch. It's the only one on this side.
God damn it.
Slow down, too.
Lock on. Too late. They woke up.
God damn it.
At 089, saying Jesus. I feel like the odd man out for not liking part three. I don't think I dislike it as much as you, but I do think it might be among my least favorite parts. Anyway,
drink.
Yeah, part three is actually commonly not like it's middle of the road for people. You either love
it
or you think it's
I love the last fight with Dio. The rest of it, I kind of think is just okay.
Part three is what got me.
Can you pass me the bottle before you start the fight?
Yeah, actually, let me pour. Refill.
I personally think you're very wrong because I think part three is amazing. But
yo, and I'm not. I don't fault anyone who likes it.
And I don't fault anyone who doesn't.
Hey, synergy.
I actually hadn't watched JoJo part one or two until earlier this year.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and I watched those. Those big, like, hour and a half long recaps. Basically, they get their story, because
I hate to say it.
I really like part two. Part one, I don't think. I think you can skip part one, honestly.
As somebody who
special skipped most of part one.
I think part one is really only important to introduce Dio specifically.
Wow, okay. You know what? This was a fucking waste.
Part two is, I think, the first, like, good part as a whole.
I think the worst thing about JoJo to me in general is just the fact that, like, the story could be condensed so much more than it is.
Yes.
On every step.
I agree with that, but at the same time, the weird level of driving in they do each part is kind of what I like when I'm watching it.
It's very,
It's an after the fact that I'm like, you could have shortened this a lot.
It's very Monster of the Week, very much like Supernatural, where it's like, oh, now we have to deal with this thing. Don't worry, the plot will show up at some point.
Part 5 was the first one. Well, I take that back. I felt that in Part 3. I didn't think it was nearly an issue in Part 1 and 2, and 4 definitely had a lot, but I think it did it well. Part 3 and 5 are the parts where I definitely get the, oh, it's just Stand of the Week fatigue.
I will say Part 3 is easily the part that needed to be shortened.
Yeah.
as much as it has a bunch of really cool ideas and sand fights and all that shit.
Drink.
That's annoying. I cannot believe. Oh shit.
Did you spill something?
Yeah. Would you mind grabbing
paper towels?
Yeah, probably best.
No.
It's not that much. I mean, a couple of drops on the table.
I just gotta wipe off my hand first, man. I'm so fucked up. I'm sorry. I'm the worst of the worst. Two people in chat are gonna get that, and God bless you both. But yeah, part three. All these really cool stand users. Then they get to Europe. And then you've got to fight the entire Egyptian pantheon of fucking stand users. And I'm like, fucking.
We started at 5, right? Yeah, so we've been going for 2 hours.
Hold on. Could you,
if anything, I feel like.
Thanks, dude. With the wet left hand.
That was a pretty good.
Are you quitting? You done?
As I admitted, I'm not in a great place at the moment.
No,
but
that's fine. I say we give it
one
more try.
I think we can give it one more go. So yeah, I know you're on like the verge of killing this thing.
Yeah, you've gotten close. And I'd love to see you give it one more shot before I finish this drink.
Oh man, everybody got sick.
That's a rough dragon rot.
Oh, could you fill me up?
Oh shit, it's the Hepus cat. It's the Venny.
Yo, the Venny!
What's up, Venny?
Welcome aboard. Love your decor.
Yeah, your butterfly picture is actually sitting in my house right now. I had to get it.
Yeah.
Good jump.
Ooh!
Not a good follow up.
All right, Scott. Now, even if you technically earn the right to respawn again, I don't know if you'll earn enough points to have that respawn.
Yeah.
So be ready.
Yeah, actually, he might.
Yeah, if you can.
Oh, wait, no, he
can,
won't.
If you can cheese this phase, you might.
Other branch. There we go. Nope.
Good. Up
that one. Nope. There we go. Lock onto the guy behind. Nope.
Oh, no!
Oh, no!
That's so
gotta calm down. Keep your wits about you.
Oh, okay, we're fine. It's okay, it's okay.
Okay. Everything's fine. You are the this is fine, dog. In that everything's on fire.
Aren't you glad that when your posture's broken, they don't go into an insta-kill animation?
That would really suck.
Although it would make you a lot more conscious about your,
Would definitely make that meter feel more important.
Oh my god! Ah, I hate that so much.
Gotta imagine she doesn't like you either, so. Kinda works out.
Indy Red B with a good take. Is Matrix the, reverse isekai?
Yeah.
If you die in the real world, you'll die in the game.
I mean, technically Matrix is an isekai.
And we're all just stuck in one big game?
Yeah.
Okay.
Behind you, branch. Find the one in back. There you go. Oh, too late. They're awake.
Wow, that barely lasted at all.
Gotta be
quick. She knew what you were up to.
Gotta be quick, calm, and calculated.
That was jump.
God damn it.
Oh. Oh. All right, last drink. Nice! Get
She's down!
There!
She's
you
down!
Nice! Okay. Now just
don't need to heal more than one pellet's worth of health, and you'll be fine.
He uses rice.
Oh, yeah, and you've got the rice. So, yeah, you've got two heals on you. You're fine.
And a res.
Goddamn, and the res. Yeah, no.
I'd use the rice if you go down and then eat that when you get back up.
Oh, okay. All right. Oh, God.
Now would
damn.
Be a good time to rice. Ah, that's a pellet.
That's fine. He's okay. Jump.
Okay, got the res.
Switch over to rice. Careful, they can chase you down pretty quick.
Okay, you got like a fifth of the health, I would say. Maybe quarter.
Not gonna eat it. Okay, bold.
Okay.
Oh my god.
You've relinquished your healing options. But do you need them? Nice, just keep wailing. Get that posture back. Yeah. Nice. Okay. Ooh, almost. The rice is still in effect.
Get her!
Good step. Oh, you.
Nice.
Be careful, though.
Ah! No! Oh,
that'll do it for me this evening. Finish your glasses with a big old drink.
I bet I can do it now too.
Well, we'll find out next time, but we will not be here next week because we will be at Anime Expo.
Yo!
The Los Angeles Convention Center.
L.A.
In Los Angeles, California. Sunny old L.A.
Yeah, I might see my brother.
Ooh,
awesome.
That'd be fun.
Awesome stuff. Well, thank you so much for joining us here tonight, everybody.
Mm-hmm.
We'll be on tomorrow for some Casual Friday with some Mario Maker.
Mario Maker 2!
Mario Maker 2.
We're going to make Mario?
The second making.
Make whole Marios.
A second making.
All right, well. Have a good night, everybody, and we'll catch you next time. Whoa! Later, but folks. Before we go,
Shit! Goddamn!
No. Gundam Fire Kenshiro with 10,300 bits. Long time watcher, first time
stream viewer.
Love you guys. Love you. Love you too. Holy shit!
Yeah.
God damn.
Shit! Fuck, dude.
Yeah.
Thank
bro.
You so much,
bro. Mm-hmm. Thank you. Oh fuck.
All right.
Almost knocked out my mic on that one. Thank you so much.
All right. You guys doing anything on Twitch later?
Nah.
I might play Hitman 2, maybe.
Nice. I'm going to play some Bloodstained to sober up.
Do it.
Twitch.tv/MastersWGS.
That's me.
Twitch.tv/Lampetor.
That's him.
Twitch.tv/KaiserNecho.
That's this guy.
And we'll see you tomorrow on Twitch.tv/StreamForStar.
Goodbye.
Kitsune no Miko, thank you for the 4 months.
Thanks for the 4 months. Bye.